That is a baby boy.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Felicitations Live, which has become a Guild 14th anniversary. I am so happy to be here. I have all my very wonderful actor friends here, part of the Guild. Thank you so much for being here, all of you. This is going to be an amazing retrospective the show. We will be taking questions from you, from the audience, so definitely ask them, throw them out. My mods will either, you know, fish them out of the morass that is chat, or we'll just pick it out ourselves. We have a lot to show you. And anybody have any questions before we show an awesome video?
Like from us?
Questions are you doing from us? Or?
You want to say something to the audience? I don't know. I'm a terrible host.
I had a great experience. That's all I can say.
I saw you guys on Sunday. Like,
yeah, I know. This isn't like a big special reunion.
I'm already tired of you guys.
Hey, we had a slideshow that I put together, and Sandeep, Sean, can you possibly pick up a couple of those pictures and just kind of so we can go through a couple, especially the one where I found that Sandeep looks 11 years old.
Like, yeah. Why do I look younger than Vince?
You really do.
I think Sandeep, you look so young then.
Did you call my 14. Mom and just ask for a photo of me?
You were 12?
Yeah.
Go to like the headshot of Sandeep. He looks like he's 14 years old.
It's the fucking shirt. It's the penguin shirt. Oh, sorry.
No, I think it's like
on the front page.
Whoa.
Okay, there it is. That's it. I won that one.
What is that?
Why am I being bored?
Oh, no. You are so cute. And you look so innocent.
I want to help you.
Crazy.
I look older than my 2-year-old.
You do.
Look at that. Oh, my gosh.
It looks like an ad for the 40-year-old virgin.
Of the 14-year-old virgin.
Oh, no.
For only $1 a day, you can help this child in need.
I genuinely cannot believe how young you look.
Oh my god,
I'm so angry.
Y'all, Danny, Jeff looks exactly the same.
Jeff has never changed.
Jeff has not changed at all.
I think Sandeep changed the most.
Jeff is 17 years old in that film.
Are you saying that Sandeep aged the most out of all of us?
Yeah, legit.
Yeah.
Oh my god, as well.
Thank you.
There's Sean. Sean looks so young. Look at that. Sean directing.
Oh my god, that van.
I think we actually had to buy that van and then we had to get rid of it.
It's in Seattle, right? Or Portland or something?
Yeah, it went to Seattle. So somebody owns that van, probably living in it.
That's amazing. Little do they know, they own a museum artifact.
Yeah, a piece of history.
Yeah. Amy, you're pretty young. Amy, that's pretty young shot.
Amy looks 13 there.
So, I was
17, 18, weren't you?
I was 18, I think.
That's hilarious.
We have so much to do. I just saw somebody throw a bunch of gift subs at me. I really appreciate that.
Hey.
If you guys would like to support the Guild all night, okay, first of all, we have t-shirts that are on half price. If you want a t-shirt, they're only like $13. So go to the little thing that's underneath my window and click that supports the Guild. Also, part of the proceeds go to Able Gamers. I installed a special overlay on the channel, as you can see, and you can follow and support everybody here. We are all streamers now. So if you guys want to make sure that you follow all of us, you can do it from the overlay and give some, you know, if you want to spread the gift sub love.
Which is
to
super
everybody,
cool. I didn't know that was a thing awesome. That Twitch mm-hmm. supported.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah, it really is awesome. So I just
there's buttons on the screen.
On the screen. Mm-hmm. And you could just literally follow right here without leaving. So definitely follow. All of us do streaming. And we'll talk about all the things that we stream later to anybody who doesn't already follow. Thank you so much for those subs. So we're going to play a video. And then we're going to be chatting and taking questions all night long until 9. But
I love it.
Sean, go ahead and play
subs.
It.
This is serious.
For all that beautiful bean footage.
So, it's Friday night, and still jobless, yay. My therapist broke up with me. Oh yeah, there's a gnome warlock in my living room, sleeping on my couch. We're a local guild. It would be easy to meet. I mean, why haven't we met before? I just have this game I play online. It's nothing important.
Sid Sherman, what is your problem?
Other than talking to my own face?
Hang with me in my MMO. Places we can go.
I'm at your doorstep. Doorstep.
Zabu?
This long distance thing is killing our relationship.
What? No, Zabu, we don't have a relationship. No, I mean, we're friends. Friends online, anonymously.
Oh, really?
It's not good.
I'm gonna stop kissing you now.
Yeah, please go.
Okay.
I am Vork, guild leader of the Knights of Good.
Vork, is it? Is there a story behind that name?
Not for you. I want it on record that as his manager, I do not discriminate against anyone who's paying. I'm equally fond of everyone. People don't like me. I elicit repugnance and resentment in humans from all walks of life.
You don't have electricity?
Once I became a non-paid professional guildmaster, I had to cut the fat from life.
Vork, electricity isn't fat.
I love spending time with my family. This is so much better than gaming.
Well, I tried an alias on another game, but my kid picked it up and started calling me Mominatrix.
Your kids are in a store right now without you?
Not entirely. Mommy's at the GameStop. I love you. Over. Kill the monsters.
Get monsters.
Tink, is that your real name?
Honey, stop grilling her.
Your real name is Fingerballa?
As far as you guys know, it is.
Well, let's go to job at a fashion magazine as the assistant to the editor.
I know I don't have the looks to fit in, but I decided to stick it out, do whatever it takes to fulfill my dreams.
Yeah, that's the plot to Ugly Betty.
What a coincidence.
I have male minions taking care of everything.
My tests, my mechanic is fixing my car battery for free.
I'm juggling 15 sets of balls today, literally.
I hate it when I'm right. Wait, no I don't.
Anyone ever tell you your character looks like that cheesy pirate dude?
Looks like that dude, buddy. I am that dude. My mom forced me into modeling to pay for college. I'm not gonna use my real name. We have rooms and badges under the name Finn Smulders, okay? I don't want stalkers showing up to my door offering me their bodies unless they're double D certified.
I'm sorry I was all douchey to you guys. It's just hard being exploited because I'm all hot and stuff.
Blaze is ready to partay. I'll have my mom drop me off.
So, it's Friday night. No longer jobless. Yay. Wow. I was such a mess when I started doing these. But now, not so much. It's because I have the guild. I guess healing them kind of helped heal me too. We're a team. We're friends. And yeah, I guess that's all I needed.
We have people in chat from Danny from Brazil was the first person to ever volunteer to do translations for the show. Oh, want to give a shout out to her. We also have Guild of Extras out there. Is Geeky Fanboy here? Oh my God, Kenny Midlighter is here.
Kenny, what's up, dude?
Oh my God. A picture of you in the montage where you're a dirty homeless person. I mean, not that homeless people are dirty. You are dirty and you are playing a homeless person. Okay. Okay. Anyway, we are.
And we're canceled. Kenny. I'm so sorry.
Good,
we're
great. Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
There's a picture. Sean, can you show the picture of Kenny? Or was it in there?
That's going to make it better? All right.
Okay. We won't do it right now.
Yeah, is this going to help?
Okay. We have a picture of Kenny. Kenny actually did one of the first after shows podcasts. So he did a guild podcast interviewing us and rolling out with each episode before anybody was doing that stuff. So Kenny was prescient. Prescient.
Anyway. Oh, is that Kenny?
No, that's Travis.
Oh my God.
Production. I don't know if there's Kim Eby. There's Kenny, see?
Oh, there he is. Kenny.
Oh.
That's funny.
Is that outside my place or?
Yeah.
Yeah. It
looks like outside your place.
Yeah.
Anyway, so we have so many wonderful people in chat. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Make sure to follow and support everybody else's channel. I have gotten all the guild into streaming this year, and it has been one of the most gratifying things. Yeah. Actually, let's go around and talk about that before we dive into old memories.
Oh, I'm scared. What did you say?
Jeff, had you ever streamed before you started streaming? We started doing D&D and stuff like that?
No. You mean... What do you mean, online or?
Yeah.
No, not at all.
Where else are you streaming, Jeff?
Well, that's what I'm trying to figure out what specific. You mean 2007?
Yeah, no, it's in the last couple of years. Like, had you ever done channel, Twitch or live streaming? Like, when did you start your channel, your streaming channel?
I think about a year ago, probably September, maybe late August.
And how many months did you play Fall Guys before you got a crown? I just want to just get that out there.
They tell me it was like 9, but I started
you set a record. August.
I think it was still February. So it was, what is that, September, October? Probably, yeah, it's too long.
Wow. But you got one and you moved on. Do you ever get tempted to go back and play a little bit more Fall Guys? There's a new season right now.
I do not. And I could have cut you off much sooner. I do not. I am not interested, please.
Okay, great. Thanks so much, Mr. Lewis. Amy Okuda. Amy Okuda, you were actually the first person. We started streaming before we even did a guild kind of D&D thing.
Because remember, okay, so basically when lockdown happened, I was having really dark days. And then my husband Mitchell was like, here, you'll like this game. And it was Stardew Valley. And I used to watch him play it all the time. And I thought it was like literally the stupidest thing ever. And he was like, just try it. And then I was like obsessed with it. I literally couldn't put it down. And then I saw that you were playing it. And I was like, oh my God, isn't it amazing? Blah, blah, blah. And then you were like, come play with me on my farm. And I was like, yeah, why not? And then it made it super easy because I was like, I don't know if I want to stream. But then you're like, just come stream with me. Mm-hmm. And like, because then we'll be doing it together, it'll be more fun. And then if you like it, then you can like start your own channel. So that's kind of how I started. So,
and you, let's be really clear about what you did in Stardew Valley. You married Shane. You divorced him. And then you did a long play rickrolling me, essentially pretending you were going to remarry Shane.
That's right. Because you were so investedly like hating on Shane.
I mean, he's a terrible choice.
That's true. I mean, look, I regretted it immediately, but like seeing how invested you were in my fake life boyfriend, ex-husband was really interesting. So
I was really worried that Mitchell, your real life husband, because you are, I mean, as strange as it is, I look at pictures from there and you had just done your high school prom, I believe, when you did the first episode of the Guild. And now you are a woman.
Is that because of the prom?
That's fun.
It's because
that night you became a woman.
That night.
Prom night is when I became a woman.
Great, you're all grown up.
But it wasn't because of prom. It was because of doing the guild.
It was because of the guild. Yeah. We grew you up.
Well, that's weird. That's weird too, right?
It's really creepy. No, right?
We all made you a woman together.
No, well, please no. Now we're really.
It takes a village.
It takes a village to make a woman.
Edgar Spoony and Jeff Valdez are in chat. We have Edgar Spoony was the original webmaster for the guild, and Jeff Valdez, the original guild leader for our in-game Knights of Good WoW guild.
Oh my God, yes.
Oh, we did those raids. Oh boy. That's right.
Yep, exactly. Vince, can you talk about you were streaming for a long time actually, right?
No, I didn't actually start until a couple months after Jeff did.
Wait, what? I thought you'd been streaming forever.
No, I just like I started. I saw Jeff was going. I saw y'all were doing it.
If Jeff can do it,
and that's my thought. If Jeff can do this, anybody can.
Jeff Lewis can.
No, but I've been told for like I don't know months, years that I should get on that and just start streaming with my off time and with COVID, with the pandemic, with all of us jumping on it. I'm like, okay, great. Like now's the time. Let's all play games together. And it turned out to go quite well. So,
I mean, you have PowerPoints on, what, 5-6 games that you present? Archbishop.
I obsess over everything I do. So, yes, I have to develop my little perfectionist methods for every game that I play.
But wait. I'm just seeing in chat that Vince is almost a year. So you haven't even been streaming a year. That blows my mind because you act like the authority on
Yeah, it's like 10
streaming.
Months. It's about 10
That's
months.
Really? What are you going to do for the year anniversary?
Well, I'm actually doing a subathon pretty soon now that I hit 10K followers. Nice. For the 1 year, I don't know. We're going to have to do some kind of big old bash. Honestly, it might end up being a charity drive. I like having big milestones go to charity more so than support
the channel. You do a lot of charity
stuff,
which is awesome.
Yeah.
Sandeep.
Yes.
So does Sandeep.
Yeah.
So Sandeep is the only person here who doesn't have his name as his channel. Mm. He has
held him back.
I wanted to make it, you know, hard to find me.
A challenge.
Yeah, like I wanted you to earn it, like the Rubik's Cube of finding me on stream.
Well, but you do a lot of good, I mean, you do a lot of really interesting stuff. What made you want, I feel like you were the last to jump. Well, Robin's technically the last to jump in, right?
Robin was the last. Robin was the last. I was second to last. Mm-hmm. I was holding out. You told me like 6 years ago that we should be streaming, and Hero was like, I don't know, way ahead of the curve and all this stuff. And I was like, nah. And then, and then there was a pandemic. And then I was like, that sounds fun.
We all have like the same story.
Pretty much.
Okay, I'll we're going to fill 2 hours of time. You go ahead and say.
Yeah, look, it's been awesome. Look, so my company, F and Funny, is a production company. And so I've got a head of production who also had nothing to do over the pandemic, and a head of development. And so Anna and Jeff. And so we were like trying to do shows. We did two big charity shows, one for the National MS Society. That was awesome. We raised them their largest single donation for the year, that because they were all their charity events were shut down because of COVID. They usually do bikeathons and walkathons and stuff. Mm-hmm. So that was like really gratifying. And and then we just do a bunch of, you know, try to do play with different formats, and it's been a blast. So thank you for introducing me to this world. It's been,
I lured you over, because I stream 5 times a week now. So it's an addiction that I need to call, because really I do. Well, what do I have to do? Anyway, Robin, lastly, and then we're going to take some questions for you guys. Robin, tell me about your foray into streaming. You were the last on board. What happened?
Well, you guys forced me to.
That's true. We did.
But I'm very thankful that you did. Ryan gave me the PC deal, and you Rycops. I was gifted a whole bunch of stuff, so I was like, well, now I have to.
I know. I bought you a mic, and I pressured you into a lot of things.
Oh, that's so nice.
I love it. It's a lot of fun. And
Chad sent you a controller.
Yeah, and I got a
controller. Oh,
really? I mean, I got a lot of stuff. And now I drink wine and cook and play video games. So I don't know.
So how does it feel looking at children who are probably in high school right now playing your kids? Like, for real. Because
I know. That's
the show is 14 years old. It is legal to get married in Alaska and Vermont with your parental consent at 14.
We're still talking like, about that, huh?
No, but like straight up, like some of her kids were like, what, 3 or 4 during the show? Like they're in their late teens now.
I think Harry was your son at one point.
Harry was Harry the little kid who goes, video games. Is that, was that Harry? I think it was.
He was just on the floor. I don't think.
Isn't one of them ninja? Like a
That's how we got to start.
Yeah.
It is. I put him in a cage. Now we're going to watch.
Changed him forever.
we're gonna watch episode 1 after we answer a couple more questions. And it's, let me just tell you, I had, so for a lot of people supported the show after, later for season 1. We put a PayPal button up. We were one of the first, this was before Kickstarter. It was before Indiegogo. We put a PayPal button up to pre-order the DVD to get money to do more than the first 3 episodes. And then I think it's episode 6 or 7 of season 1, I put some children in a cage. And unfortunately, the children don't look happy in the cage, okay?
But it was done safely, and like parents were right there.
It was also really funny.
Oh, it was hilarious. Yes.
Yeah. It's true.
But I had many people be like, I'm never supporting you again because of this. And at the time, I was like, whoa, these ladies are overreacting. And like now as a mom, I'm like, how dare they do that? So, okay. I have a couple of questions from the audience. What is one of your favorite moments shooting the guild? So do you guys have a favorite moment where especially made you laugh a lot?
I do, actually.
Oh, good.
I think my favorite moment, I want to say this is from season 2, and there's a lot of them, but the one that for me really like sent it home, both in terms of showing me what kind of like quality of talent we had on the cast, and the most fun I had shooting was the first time that I got to act in a scene opposite Sandeep and Jeff. in season two.
Go on.
And
Now you're open.
And the scene was almost like it was at least 60% improvised by these guys at minimum. And I notoriously could not keep my shit together. It was not fun for the crew.
I don't think there was ever a day you couldn't.
The scene with Bruiser and the I banged your mom scene in the garage, I wasted 21 takes. That took me 22 takes to get that shot. And it wasn't even that great of a take.
You were young. And
I was 15
you
years
were a problem.
Old. Everything's funny to me, especially these two fuckers were killing me.
Okay, PG, thank you.
These two lads.
These two scamps. Exactly. Thank you.
Oh, no, PG.
Was the moment that I'm like, oh my God, we are like, we're in for something. This is hysterical and I'm ruining the shot.
No, you did ruin many shots. I think Sean, at a certain point. Now, I want to just give a shout out to the person who's doing the awesome camera switching, Sean Becker, who is the amazing director of seasons 2 through 5 of The Guild. So I just want to give a shout. He is still with the show, and he's awesome. He's also a streamer as well, and he's much better at Fortnite than I am. The Guild is not capable of doing a PG stream. You know, we're going to try.
I know.
Anyway.
I've got two more in me.
This is the closest we've done so far.
This is actually very good. We're good. Amy, do you have any memories of The Guild or the show or filming
anything?
Or your favorite?
I genuinely was just thinking about this, and I knew you guys were going to say this. I don't remember a ton from the actual
nightmare.
Only a few,
because I don't know. I just feel like I was always just like trying to get through it. You know what I mean? Like I felt like I was like, I didn't have anything to do, but I felt like I was just like, I don't know. Like I was
trying to survive it.
Yeah, yeah. I think I was just trying to like survive it. But I do remember the things I remember are like the conventions. I think those are like the happy, like, memories, I think, like when we got to like travel and like, you know, all the San Diego Comic Cons, like how we were like squeezed in with like 7 different booths like the first couple of years, and then just like seeing it grow and like going to all these conventions meeting. I don't know, I think that's
Dragonling Teacher is in the audience and was evidently an extra in season 6. Do you remember how hot it was season 6 set? Yes, it was terrible. Oh, I feel so bad about all the background. And if anybody's an extra in any shot, they're either cast or crew, or they volunteered and came from Twitter and just hang out, and we fed them. But it was not, I mean, it was not like a TV show, y'all. It was like kind of like we are shooting in my house. You will see a lot of those pictures. People were literally crowded around a bathroom, sitting in a bathtub trying to look at the monitor. And it kind of, when I look
at it. You know what I do remember, though, from shooting is every time I shot at your house, my like I was so itchy and my face was like so puffy all the time because I'm allergic to cats.
Oh yeah, same.
And like I never said anything, but like
you do that or
Amy. Yeah, I'm allergic to cats. And I remember like the first couple times I'm like, why am I getting like this? Am I nervous or whatever? And then I realized that I'm allergic to cats.
Speaking
and then Felicia
cons,
just yelling at you like, get your lines right. And you're like,
I do that.
Speaking
do
of cons,
not.
We've also got Jamie Chambers in chat who, like, some of our earliest con memories are
Jamie
with that
show. Jamie Chambers.
That's
who.
Okay, true story. Let me tell you a story about Jamie Chambers. So he worked for a company, or his company had a corner booth, and we couldn't find booth space because you can't get a booth there. And he was so kind to give us space in that booth, and they were shooting. I don't know if you guys remember, they shot a San Diego Comic-Con documentary with Morgan Spurlock and a bunch of really famous people producing it. They picked me to follow. So somewhere on the cutting room floor is Felicia Day agonizingly trying to put together IKEA crates to put our shirts in so we could sell them to fund the show. And Jamie was there. He had to hug me when I was crying because I literally couldn't put these IKEA shelves on there.
That's precious.
True story from The Guild. It was all DIY, y'all.
Before I forget, wasn't there a sign you put up in your bathroom that said, do not poop?
That was going to be my thing.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No,
it wasn't a favorite.
Because I was trying to remember what that sign was. It was some version of like, don't poop here or something. Or it was like, flush twice or
stop. Flush twice.
Leave the fan on.
stop.
Yes, Edgar, you did get us no extra pooping. Furniture for the con. Edgar went and got us chairs because he didn't have enough chairs, and they wouldn't legally allow us to get 6 chairs in the booth, but he persuaded someone to allow us to get 6 chairs in our booth. So thank you. True story, Felicia stress cried on Wednesday before every San Diego. It's true.
That's, I think, yeah.
Every Wednesday, I think we all stress cry.
Okay, so Jeff, do you have another memory besides the pooping? I don't remember that, but
you know,
I'm sure it's there.
I think early on, I didn't know everybody, but so when we did big cast scenes, it wasn't that big a deal. But I think later on, like I remember being in the van with everybody. Like that was my most fun when all of us were together in one scene. That yeah. always...
Like season 5, the
what
con.
What van?
Yeah.
The van that I think I almost ran over. I tried
season
to run down.
The Axis.
I think
yeah,
was
but we were in the van season
well, no,
5
season,
too.
Because in season 5, we all got into a van to drive yeah. to the convention.
Yes. That's true. Yeah.
And,
yeah.
Yes. Okay. And I started to run over a whole table, all these tables filled with people.
I remember that. Yes. Yeah.
Right.
And but I'd you were also in the van for season, like looking for Wi-Fi. That was
season. That's what I was thinking. That was season 3.
Oh, yes.
But he was
yes.
in there by himself, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was because I remember there was a little clip of it in the tenure thing where the gardener blew his face with the, which I thought was literally
oh,
the
yes.
funniest thing.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's hilarious.
But that was fun.
There's like a Reservoir Dog shot of all of us like walking in slow motion.
Yes.
Oh, coming
there
out
is
the
in
van.
That back
yes.
alley.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's I had a monitor.
And I remember, I feel like I remember the art director or someone came up to me and he's like, dude, we don't have a permit to film here. We got to do this quick,
oh,
man.
Oh yeah. That's
right. All the time
like,
we tell
oh,
you.
What? I'm like, okay.
We never had a permit.
We never
had a permit. Yeah.
Permits are expensive.
They are very expensive. And we were always like tense. Like I was always tense because basically anybody could have reported. Like I technically shouldn't have been shooting in my house. And it would have been fine with like the, because season 1 we had like 4 people, but like it ballooned to be so much bigger. And it was really just a real film shoot. Thank goodness for my neighbors for not reporting us to the authorities.
Dad, this is between us, okay?
Exactly. So many Guild of Extras here. Thank you guys so much. And Jenny Powell. In chat,
Jenny.
So
amazing.
Wow.
Robin, do you have a memory that you'd like to share?
Yeah, I think season 5, the convention was a lot of fun, and doing steampunk was pretty rad.
Yeah.
That was
a lot
of fun.
That was amazing.
That was really cool. I got to look like a badass. So
you looked so good in that hole. I really wish I had done a spinoff with that. I wish we had had enough to be able to do that.
Good. And then that hanging out with so Doug good. Jones and Jillian,
Doug
like
Dougie.
All
oh
the
my
time.
God, Doug
yeah.
Jones is amazing.
That was a good time.
Yeah. Wonderful.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Season 5 was a big blur for me, I feel.
Really? Season 5 was my favorite season to film, I think.
It was,
especially
yeah,
all the hotel
too.
Shots, all the party shots
yeah.
and stuff were so much fun.
It was
with all the guest stars that we brought in.
It was right in the middle of my finals, I remember.
Oh no. I remember
then,
you were studying a lot.
And then remember those twin girls? Remember those twin girls
yes.
that didn't show up?
Oh my God.
So like we were just waiting for them. And then I was like, I literally have to go because I have a final.
No, I remember
really
that.
Close. They're really close. They're really close. And they were in Phoenix.
They lied. They said
they
their agent.
Came. They yeah. never came.
Yeah, they were the Devilment twins, I guess. I don't mean to out them, but they totally blew the guild off. They played the Devilment twins. And we were trying to have identical twins for her sisters. And like the night before we called them and then they didn't show up the next morning. And then finally, like several hours into the morning, their agent was like, they're in Arizona.
Ugh.
And I was like, what are you talking about? They're in Arizona. We offered to buy them a car and pay for the rental. Then they said they're driving in every hour. They said, we're just an hour away by 3 p.m. They were like, they're not coming.
To be fair,
though,
did they double our fun?
You had a great solution, though.
What we did to resolve that. I forget her name. I'm so sorry,
Leslie,
but the woman who stepped in to play the twins,
yeah,
just one person.
Leslie,
how you guys contrived that shot to make her look like two people
was so good.
It turned out so good.
Yeah,
that was Sean Becker and Chris Darnell, right? Did I get that name right, Sean?
Yeah.
Nailed it.
Darnell.
It
Chris
was
awesome.
A longtime DP. Sean, yeah, we all came up. We were like, what are we going to do? Also, Donna Ricci for all the steampunk outfits.
Donna's wonderful.
Oh, my
Donna's
God.
Wonderful. She owns Geeky Tees in Burbank. So
love it.
Go to a
great
really
spot.
Cool,
great spot.
She's
awesome
a dungeon.
Place. Yeah, so Leslie, who had never acted before at all, she just loved WoW and playing and loved the show. We were like, hey, would you like to be two people? And she had to do super complicated stuff and
the blocking
learn
was
lines.
Intense. Yeah.
And she did a great idea. So that was a true story.
She had to like go around the camera and then duck and sneak past the legs of some actors to pop That's up on insane. The other side. Like it was crazy. It was awesome.
And she, then in
she,
one of the yeah.
she was an extra. She started out as an extra. Is that
she
what
was just an extra. She you yeah. can actually see her as an extra. We had to cut her out of other scenes that she was an extra in.
Wow.
I played the other twin when she was standing here. So because we would shoot everything twice right. and
over
I put on a blonde wig.
Oh my gosh.
Amazing.
It is an amazing story. And I've never said who those girls are, but I mean, they're the Double Mint twins.
Here so. It is. We said they have look 14 years. That's all
they're
they
very
get.
Very pretty, very and nice. I'm sure public. It was just cross wow. wires, guys.
You know, that happens.
All right. Well, it is 7:30, and I think in order to really keep this train going, we're going to take questions from you guys all night. The mods are taking them out, so please post them. We are going to now watch the first episode. Wait. Are we doing the comic first? We're doing the comic first, right? Let me look at my own run of show.
No, I think we're
I think
the
episode's
show.
First.
Yeah, let's do the episode. Yeah. All right, Sean, you ready? We're going to play episode one and watch us be babies.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
Except for me.
But there's no profanity in it. Oh, well.
So, it's
Wait, are we,
Friday
like,
night.
Talking over
and
this, or just...
we can a little
still
bit.
Jobless, yay! I haven't left the house in a week.
That's Kimberly
My
Lewis, right? You're talking to.
Broke up
That's
with
right.
me. Her oh yeah, Lewis. there's a gnome warlock in my living room.
Oh,
sleeping on my
Sean,
couch.
We can't really hear the sound anymore. There we go. Okay. Yeah, Kimberly Lewis was
the original intro. Oh my God.
Kim Eby, Kimberly Lewis, and Jane Sully Morgan, who was the director. Oh. Everybody help make this a woman support.
Wait, so you're firing me? That's so awesome. I mean, you're my therapist. Is that,
what
is that
a
even
shot.
Medically legal? How is that legal?
I can't.
I'm sorry, Sid, but you don't seem willing to work on your addiction.
I've been establishing the parameters.
That's my bedspread.
Like
I still have that.
Kind of.
You can't grow if you're still immersed
Remember
in an imaginary
landlines, you guys?
Environment.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
I'm dying. I need heals. Heal me.
Incoming.
Hey, there's our boy.
I play with real people.
Have you met them face to face?
I remember
I,
that bed.
Hear
I tried
them.
To hit myself
the
with a
cord,
controller cord on that bed.
Okay, Dr. Hammond, you're killing me. Like, literally.
Actually, we lost this location after the first half of the season, huh? So we had to.
Well, this isn't your house.
Forget it.
Where was
nobody
that?
Nobody noticed.
Repeat.
It was the director, James.
Bork is
house.
Down.
Oh.
Changed to Kim's house later.
That's
look at
your
Bork.
House.
Oh
look
my
that
God.
Griddle.
Look
we took it
that
back
was
after
a total
we shot.
Rim job, Codex. I was being raped by goblins, and you're standing there with your staff up your ass.
Dropping Oops, the R sorry. Word in.
Tinkerbell.
You see?
You're legal before. No finger pointing.
She didn't come to my
How
house.
How many R-bombs do we get?
Their finger.
Blades. Guild rule number 12.
Ooh, Daddy Guild Leader's so angry.
I cannot get your hair.
I also
need
to
play
this
game
too
something
much.
Else.
Yeah, so then I web surf.
It's really something.
Look, some chicken China squirted out an 18-pound baby. Check the link.
Damn.
Some
Claire's
China.
Back. Sorry for AFKing. My Aww. Stupid nanny left without feeding Bellamy again.
This baby
oh,
is out.
Ninja.
Gabby,
ninja.
Tomorrow, monsters should use the microwave.
Is
so,
baby?
Did Zabu show up yet? Right?
No.
Those kids are 15, 17 now.
And I'm docking as we speak.
Oh my gosh.
Let this be a lesson.
Are they in chat?
Weird. Zabu never
misses.
How many
yeah.
takes did that take?
Yeah, even when his uncle died from
many,
it.
Actually.
Not many, yeah. yeah. I'm very good.
He didn't say anything about taking time off, did he?
Oh, God.
That's the best.
Oh, my God.
That's
you guys.
The best.
Zabu hasn't been on
39
hours.
You insisted that it be plugged in. That was...
Yeah,
that
impressive.
What?
Not a bad
heck?
Actor.
Yeah.
Did you see that DS that you had? That was so old. Oh, these poor children.
That's like 2 days, right? Nursing makes me stupid.
You're nursing right now? That's freaking hot.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Nice.
Nice.
Hold
that.
That's a gross joke.
I'll be right back.
Nothing like some lactation humor.
I've already seen five
Hi.
Things I would rewrite.
Hi, Sid Sherman. These are for you.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Yeah. Bam, and that's when the tour de force arrives.
Oh!
I'm spray painting myself.
Oh my God, you're 12.
Thanks. They're
why? Why did you let Thank me do you. That with my hair? I was like, I want to look really stupid, and you're like, okay.
Nice boy.
Oh my God.
I thought you wanted to look really hot. That's
Sorry,
what you
know
said.
Me.
That's what you thought.
That's not what I said. So I picked
remember,
like my worst
flower
outfit.
From last week.
Oh,
back to me.
You still have that
I
shirt?
I bought a blue flower for you.
Yeah, my parents bought that from Bali.
And, you know, it's totally worth the money. It was a lot, but it was worth it.
Zabu?
Yeah. Yes, Zabu. Right. I'm at your doorstep. Doorstepped.
Hey!
Bam!
Wow.
He said the thing.
Oh my god! I remember.
Oh, I hate the bangs. Why were those two bangs there? I hated it.
Like, they were just like they wanted to say hello.
Y'all, I want to apologize for some of the writing so there. That's very clearly 14 years old. I would never have put the R word into a new thing. I would never have said several of those things.
Tink would have said it.
Tink would have, for sure.
For sure.
I'm getting a 2006 emo vibe. Victor, it was 2007, okay?
So, like, clearly, it was 2007, okay?
Yeah. Does anybody remember shooting those first episodes? Like,
yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
We shot my lines on the monitor. I remember that.
Yeah.
I think we shot the first, didn't we shoot the first couple episodes at the same time? Because we had the whole rest of that scene and stuff in the house. I feel like that was like my first day on set.
Yeah, I think we shot the first three episodes together. And I'm not kidding you guys. It cost like, I think that the three of us, me and Jane and Kim, spent like six or $700 total.
Oh, wow. God.
We had so many people give us stuff for free. We just literally, I went and got garbage from the streets. I'm not kidding. A lot of that is garbage.
That she paid for.
That's what it takes.
Garbage she paid for. It was free.
Yeah. And, so as far as casting goes, my friend Kellen Geyer, who casted maybe my first student film, it was a black and white, no sound film for USC. And actually the creator of that went on to write a book with Mel Gibson, or not Mel Gibson, but somebody, God, some famous actor he wrote a really cool graphic novel with. Anyway, Rick Ross, I think. Anyway. So she cast me in that, and then I asked her, please cast this, because I wrote parts for my friend Sandy and Jeff, because I did improv at them at a place called the Empty Stage Theater, which you'll see in the credits as a thank you, which we is subsequently not there yet. But I had to cast the other three. So my friend Helen cast Amy and Robin and Vince. And it was like the minute they entered the room, it was like so clear that it was them.
Aww. Although I watched that and I'm like, oh my god, why did
they? Do you have?
Oh,
you
wait,
have
the imposter. Yep.
There was a point where they just had to go with whoever they got. You know what
it's
I mean?
It's true. Like literally, how many
ages?
Wasn't there something with the first Clara or something like that?
Was there an original Clara?
Wait, no. You were always it. No, you. Okay, wait.
Oh no,
no
we're talking about this.
Was, yeah,
you almost didn't get Clara? You almost didn't get an audition because Helen didn't pick you, but I'm such an obsessive. I went through her actor access and it just pulled in anybody I thought was interesting.
Oh,
and
wow.
You had one of the worst headshots I've ever seen.
Headshot. The cookie headshot.
Oh, you had a ladle and a cooking hat on, and you were like,
"Oh my god,
it was bad."
Oh my god, that is amazing.
Wait, I want to see that photo.
Yeah, can we find
that?
We gotta
dig that up. We got a
ladle and a cooking hat.
Yeah,
I could not find a digital copy. Robin, you could find it and put it on your channel.
Really
yes.
No.
And I was like, I kind of like.
It was bad. Wow. I mean, I looked cute, but it was bad.
You were very
cute. It's like my modeling photos.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it wasn't a joke. Maybe that, Robin needs to post that in Discord, please.
Except I don't. I mean, I don't even think I have. Yeah, I don't.
It's the best $25 you ever gave to a guy in a windowless white van.
Yeah, for sure.
I think I had it somewhere because I wanted to put it in my book, but we couldn't find the original photographer to get permission. So,
something
that's
like that.
So funny.
Oh my god, that is funny.
It sounds like a stretch goal, exactly. Yeah. And I want to remind the audience, if you are watching and you are new to us, all of us stream. And if you look at the overlay, you can see an easy way to follow every single person on the screen if you would like to. Everybody streams at different times, different games, but all of them are awesome. And we generally play together on Sundays.
Good job, Jeff.
Can I tell you this, that I got your voicemail on my answering machine. Oh, and you said, I want you to come and do this reading. And I had just done like about six or seven like short films in a row for free. And I was so burned out and tired of doing them. I said to my wife, I didn't want to do it. She goes, well, just do it. You have nothing else going on at all.
Oh, no.
She said, you have nothing at all going
on.
Oh,
my God.
Do it. I was like, all right, fuck it.
Amy, didn't you also almost not like go?
No, yeah. I mean, I auditioned thinking that it said like TV pilot or something.
Oh,
yeah.
It did.
So, like,
it did
yeah,
say
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
I honestly, well, first I didn't really know anything about anything at that point. I mean, I still don't think I know anything about anything, but
I just like went and I did it. And then like, they're like, you got it. And I was like, oh my God, great. Like, this is so easy. It was like literally one of my like first acting auditions. I was like, this acting thing is so easy. And then like, as more details came out, I was there. They're like, it's a web series. And I was like, what the hell is a web series? And they're like, it's on YouTube. And I was like, what the fuck is YouTube?
Do they know who I am?
But then again, it was like my first thing. So I was like, I mean, who am I to say no to anything, right? So
yeah, you almost didn't want to show up because it was the day after your prom. And you were like, oh,
that's right. Yes, that's right.
Yeah, you almost bailed.
Yeah.
So yeah, YouTube was brand new. Like, honestly, I didn't even know that much about YouTube. My friend Kim Evie, who was all this the producer as well of the guild through the whole thing and also created Geek & Sundry for me, with me. She had uploaded a couple videos called Gorgeous Tiny Chicken Machine Show right when YouTube started. And I guess David Spade made it go viral and then it got bought by Sony and they made a whole series. So she was the one who was like, hey, this new video stuff is cool. Let's make something. And I was like, I don't understand this at all. I just know the guy with the lightsaber who every... and the, yeah, exactly. So
I remember there was a show called Quarter Life. That was the first, it was a web series.
Quarter Life. Totally. Yeah.
But that was, I don't know, that I think it was before Guild. I'm thinking maybe, I don't know.
I think it was after. I think it was like a year after. It was 2008. Cause I feel like it was after us. I'm just going to say that. Fatal the Baptist. asks, did anyone take any props or swag from the set during the whole show run? Did
I think a bunch probably.
I think I still have the suit.
Oh, you
I had to keep the steampunk outfit, which is really cool.
The only thing that I really wanted to keep that I could not get my hands on was the costume from Date My Avatar. That was the one thing that I'm like, I want that so bad.
Why didn't you tell me? I auctioned it off. I think I asked if people wanted their costumes, and I auctioned them for Penny Arcade.
I don't know. I think maybe that's when, because I know I talked to the costumer who actually made the thing, and she's like, I don't know where it is.
No,
and
I had it. I would have given it. I think I offered the outfits to everybody.
I feel like by the time you mentioned it, I knew that I would never fit into it ever again.
I mean, it's so true. I see pictures of me in that outfit.
That thing was like sewed onto my body while I was in it, I remember at one point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I had to peel mine off.
I think I got a free vasectomy out of it, actually.
Mine didn't work.
It didn't work though, huh?
Didn't take.
Yeah, I'm very patient.
It didn't take.
I got a guy.
I think that only Codex's outfit is in the Smithsonian, which I visited.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Did you really?
I sent pictures.
That's right.
Oh yeah, that's it's true. Yeah.
Because my family in DC, it's amazing. There's the guild is in the Smithsonian.
I mean, that's insane.
Where's
they
the
have
bus?
A copy,
older.
They have What's a that? Copy of the original script. And they have the Codex outfit. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
And then all of our, like, we have a giant photo of all of us in our avatar. Like, the photo of us that we signed and gave away, like, our avatar photos is in the Smithsonian. Mm-hmm. So my parents took pictures of themselves next to it and stuff.
Oh, my God.
That's so great. That's really neat.
Everyone just added that they don't read Sandeep's text and pictures. That's right. That's so true.
We do. We don't remember two days in a second.
I have no memory of this.
No, I have
no memory.
Viswa made the guild outfits in his emote harp form. Yes, Viswa, thank you so much. Each one of us has a custom emote from one of my mods, Viswa, that imitates our outfit, which is... And by the way, if I get a DMCA for playing that first video with the song that I own, I'm going to go ballistic on Twitch.
Yeah. Well, that's right.
That'd be funny.
No, you own... Right, you own it.
I know.
We're going to say all the bad words on front page.
What's the problem?
Yeah. Oh, no, I get takedown notices all the time on YouTube from the person that I pay to... put it on iTunes so people can buy it. And I got DMCA notices to take down the guild episodes because somebody claimed that Geek & Sundry owned it. And I was like, no, you don't. So yes. I get DMCA. I'm full of DMCA all the time. Wow. I'm very good at DMCA. You guys, let's see another question. When did you first get the idea that you should do music videos? Avatar is amazing. Thank you, MST3K Temple.
It is.
So I was writing season 3 and I put together a terrible playlist of dance music because I was such a bad, I mean, I really can't write fast at all and I really needed to get going. And so I put together a whole thing and I had just done Dr. Horrible. So my mind was on doing music and my friend Jen Whedon, who was one of the writers of that and is an amazing musical artist, lived really close to me. And I basically was like, hey, this is a funny idea. Let me just write down some lyrics and send it to him. And within a day, he sent me the lick, the refrain, and like totally built out the whole song. And I was like, oh my God, this is going to be the best song ever. So that was how it happened. And to be honest with you, when I was looking for these, and the second song was Sandeep's idea. Sandeep, when did you, you're the one who pitched me a Bollywood.
That's
idea.
A great song.
Yeah, yeah, I think it was just, hey, I'm Indian, let's take advantage of this. And let's do a Bollywood setup. I thought that'd be just super fun and get us all in really fun outfits and doing big dance sequences. And we got an elephant. It was a fake elephant, but it was the amazing. Size of an elephant.
That was really
cool. I gotta say, the songs though, like all the songs still slap. Like they really hold up well. They're great songs.
I want to tell you guys, I found two songs I actually wrote that we never did.
What?
I found a song called Alone Together, right, which was overdramatic Taylor Swift, Sauce Focus, contemplative ballad for gamers. It was a
that's hilarious.
And then the other one was Quetzal. It was a Quetzal, which is a dance thing. It's like a dance that's on a keyboard. So I
remember you like pitching this or something.
I wrote all the lyrics out.
We've got to make these.
Is it like a Macarena or something?
It's like a Macarena.
It's a stepped dance, right?
Q key, move to left. W says straight and deft.
That's right.
Oh, wow. That's really
funny. Oh, holy crap. We have to make these.
I mean, I wrote the whole thing. It's amazing. Yeah. Anyway, so I found them.
Oh, chat's losing it.
Yeah.
Make them.
Okay.
Well, that was really rad when we premiered the first music video at Comic-Con and people lost their shit.
And then we came out in the costume.
Oh, and then all hell broke loose. That was cuckoo.
I've never heard people scream so loud in my life.
That was
still my favorite part though was before we showed up, we all took a stripper bus.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my
yes.
God.
Oh my God, the party bus.
And
oh
yes.
My
God.
With the stripper pole. Yeah.
Oh, that was amazing.
We all took turns on.
Yeah.
So it was my idea.
We never got treated that well ever again.
No, we weren't. Xbox was really wonderful to us because the first season we actually, and somebody asked me, did you really hand stuffed the first year DVDs. We did. On the floor of my house, we had to figure out how to mass print like return envelope things. And I started crying because we had to assemble them and put the sleeve in ourselves and put them in an envelope. I had to buy thousands of envelopes that would only fit the DVD. And then we didn't realize that we needed to charge more for shipping to like Israel. So we were losing money.
Oh my goodness.
Who did you ship them through?
We just took them to the post office.
No, but I mean, there was no Amazon. Did people order it from your site?
PayPal. Was just PayPal. That's it. There was no way to fulfill anything back then. There was no Kickstarter.
Y'all don't realize like how much hands-on work Felicia and Kim and these guys did during the show. When we shot I'm the One That's Cool, in all of the like the middle school, high school bathroom scenes, when they dunk me, holding me in the air upside down into a toilet, that was a real public middle school toilet.
I'm so sorry, bitch.
And literally, for the hour preceding that shot, Felicia and Kim were on their hands and knees scrubbing every little inch of that toilet. And I'm like, guys, I'll probably be fine. Like, it's okay.
No,
could you imagine
we
doing
it.
That? Like, can you imagine doing that post-COVID?
No.
No.
And then the guys holding me hit my head on the toilet, and my life has never been the same.
I feel like you were definitely the only one who would do that. Like,
I requested
okay
that kind of
that,
stuff.
Yeah.
There's no
I
way.
I love that kind of stuff. I remember having conversations with Felicia and Kim and everybody, and Sean as well. Like, you guys, do whatever you want to me. Like whatever bit you want to do, that's just like no one else will do.
He got a real swirly. He got a real authentic swirly. Yeah,
I would do a lot, but I don't know if I would do that. That's really interesting.
Yeah, I do it again.
Sure.
I do it now.
Like a real toilet?
I would do it if they like replace the water. But like, how do you even do that? You
know, I was down to be beat up by a stuntman. Like I was cool with that. Fernie.
Yeah. I mean, you guys threw a rubber ball on my face.
Yeah, and it was slow motion. Yeah. We had to do it a lot, actually, because your head is so large. Like, it was hard to get the, to get the angle.
And it's so perfectly spherical.
It's actually a perfect circle. Amen.
Yeah,
I actually do have a big head, remember? Because none of my season 5 wigs fit my head.
No, you, guys, you had, I was,
you guys ordered, I ordered all these wigs. None of them fit my head.
To this day, I could not, this is why I probably should not That's be insane. Making any videos anymore, which I probably, you know, I don't really see that in my future, but I was so obsessed with you wearing a Marie Antoinette wig. And I was so upset that your head was too big for it. Like, I was honestly like, what could
you
do?
Bought like a child's back? Wig, I feel like.
It was a child's wig.
It was a children's wig. And then remember that plushie? I had like a plushie like outfit and Kim Peavy had to wear it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
because
I remember that.
Because the head wouldn't fit my head.
Yeah, there's a scene in season 5 that you were wearing a plush version of yourself, but she couldn't fit it. So Kim... So Amy had to do her lines off camera and Kim had to wear the outfit.
Just to
like miming, yeah.
Okay, she captured your essence perfectly though.
It's true.
Very alike.
Good Dog has a really good question. Tell us the first time you got recognized from being in the guild. Oh, do you remember God. You guys?
I remember,
or any memorable
I remember mine.
Thing?
It was Felicia, I think you and I went to South by Southwest. And I've told this story before, but I'll tell again. We were walking down the street and in Austin and people just spotted us and they were like, oh my God, you're Zabu from the guild. You're Codex. And I just remember thinking in that moment, I was like, I just couldn't like believe it. Like, I just couldn't believe that someone could pick me
up.
Not
buying it.
Yeah.
I was like, do you know, like, you must know this person. Cause like Felicia's from Austin. And I was like, oh, you know, and then they're like, yeah, they didn't know us at all. And I just was
in
so,
disbelief.
And I remember thinking literally, I was like, wow, I can't believe that they can tell me apart from under other Indians. Like, like in my heart was like, wow, I can't believe that like I was distinguishable. Like
I
literally couldn't believe it. It was really weird.
It's so weird because it's still just a disconnect, you know, because we live in a world of Hollywood, right? And so it's a different world. Like even at the height of the fame of the guild, nobody in Hollywood really cared about what we were doing. And it was always a surprise, like, what are you doing? You know, and which is really ironic because when you hear like the finale of Baskets got like 60,000 views or whatever on a major television show, right? Mm-hmm. Or like the finale of Girls got 200,000 viewers or whatever. Like we always had more than that. And yet we never had any budget. And we always were just kind of doing it outside of any acknowledgement of Hollywood, which is like, you know, it just is what it is. I don't know if things would be different now, but you know, you'd never, I mean, look at Critical Role. Like I'm sure nobody in Hollywood is like, oh, look at Critical Role. You know, they're always going to be underground things that are kind of out of the mainstream. And quite frankly, that's where I like to live anywhere.
Better. I call it being, sure. I think it's like being Fight Club famous. We're like a random person somewhere is kind of like looks at you and is like, I know you. It's like, you know,
I know you.
At any group, if there's like 1,000 people somewhere, I'm like, someone here is a guild fan, like at Disney.
Yes.
And then someone is going to find me somewhere and be like, you're from the, like, you know, from the guild.
And there are always people who I would want to hang out with. That's the thing that I like. I would hate to be on a show where it's like people like was like, you know, like somebody who I would never on site I would never hang out with was like, I love your show. That the cool thing about our show is that we're kind of like our fans, you know what I'm saying? We're the same kind of people. We really like games organically and we share a lot in common with the people who like what we made back then. So
yeah.
Edgar asks, hey Sandeep, do you remember the Photoshop shirt I wore when I first met you guys at PAX in 2008 with your face and mine next to it?
Yes, I do. Yeah, it's etched into my memory. It's burned in, never to be removed.
Yeah.
Edgar's awesome.
Yeah, he is pretty awesome. Does anybody else remember being recognized that just kind of blew their mind?
I remember, well, I'm sure the first time we were like recognized was probably definitely like at a convention, but then I remember the first time I was recognized like in the real world, I was at my college football game and none of my college friends knew that I was doing this show. They didn't even know that I like wanted to be an actor or anything.
We're hiding us. Yep.
And what?
Said you were hiding us.
You're ashamed.
I was hiding it. I was like a closeted actor. And then one of the security guys getting into the football game was like, oh my God, like you're Tink. And I was like, what?
What?
I was like, what are you talking about? And then like, he wanted a picture and we took a picture. And then my friends were like, wait, what is he talking about? What? And then obviously like I had to tell them I was with like maybe 2 or 3 girls. And then so I had to tell them. And so they were like the 3 girls in college that like knew.
Wow.
And they had
they had to keep it a secret. And
your
they
dirty
still,
little secret.
They still call me Tink to this day.
Are you kidding? Cute. Well,
I don't
I
think I remember like my first, but it was definitely, I remember it being something banal. Like, I think I was with my dad at the DMV or something. And someone just walked up like, hey, Blades. And I'm like, oh, what? Hi. I don't know. I'm 15. Like, what's up?
That's amazing. Danny from Brazil. Here's something crazy. I got recognized here in Brazil once. I was wearing a Guild t-shirt. Someone saw me at a mall and was staring at me. And after a few minutes, asked if I was the one who subtitled the Guild and was in the Guild chat all the time.
Wow. Oh, that's my God. That's amazing.
Ernie Dork says, I recognize Robin's laugh when I was working at a bar.
Ernie,
so cool.
I remember Ernie.
Very distinctive laugh.
That was in San Diego, and it was a hilarious evening.
Yeah.
And he's
I always love being around Robin.
You're from the Guild.
No, yeah. Go ahead.
I always love being around Robin and being recognized because everybody remembers like Robin's drinks. And so then we always end up getting drinks bought for us.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes.
Like every time.
Yeah. I mean, listen, I'll take one for the team. I'll take one for you. It's for you.
Vodka-tonic.
Yeah.
But could we talk about how we got Amy married also? Like, Amy's married only because of the Guild?
Is that a fact?
Yes, it's true.
Only because of the Guild?
Yep.
It's actually probably a fact. Yeah. So my husband and I have known each other since eighth grade. Like, he was my eighth grade boyfriend, but then we didn't talk for a long time between like high school and college. And at it was the BlizzCon where I got booed.
Which one was that?
Oh my god.
2009. I remember that.
And
the one where you said, like, what did you say? Like, wow.
Well, you were sitting in between Sandeep and I, and you said what you said, and we were like,
like, they asked you if you play WoW, and you were like, no, like, I have a life.
No, I have a life.
Or like something like that.
I don't game, I have a
life. The crowd audibly booed you.
Okay, let's get back to the real, the happy story, okay?
But also, people at BlizzCon thought that we were like a legit.
Yes, they were being a little bit like mean about it because like
they didn't understand we were actors.
They did not understand we were actors because it was like
a question, like, and it sounded like they thought the Guild was real.
Yeah.
Like, we're pretty sure.
Yes. Yeah.
I think Sandeep said it like
you know
half a dozen
actors,
times.
He
you
did.
Know
I did.
Right?
I kept saying, like, we're actors on a show.
You guys know it's not real, right?
Yeah.
Anyways, so that BlizzCon, Mitchell was also like, he was like a huge closeted gamer. Uh-huh. And he would meet up with his Guild at BlizzCon, and his friends were like, we're going to go to this Guild panel. And he was like, okay, fine, like, whatever. And then we were walking to the panel, and he was walking to the panel, and I was like, Mitchell? And then he looked at me, and I swear to God, the first thing he said was, don't tell anyone I'm here. And I was like, I literally haven't seen you in like almost 10 years. Like, who am I gonna tell? But he was like,
don't
such
tell
a
anybody
positive
I live
gamer.
Like this.
And then he was like, what are you doing here? And then I told him about the show, and he's like, that's where we're going. And then I got booed, and then we just kept in touch as friends. And then that's how we like reconnected. And then several years later, we started dating.
Wow. That's
that awesome. Girl getting dunked on, that's the one for me right
there. Yes. Yes. Nothing like a girl like getting booed to make her
love with you. That's when you fell in love with you, Amy.
Yeah.
She's vulnerable.
He just felt sorry for me, probably.
Here's another person. Edgar says, I was recognized at a tech convention. They saw me and asked if I was E.G. Spoody, and they thanked me for all the work that I did with Felicia and the Guild.
Wow, that's awesome.
That's incredible.
That is pretty rad.
I mean, I would think the Guild of Extras, they were like in every season.
Yes, they really were.
Yeah.
You could probably follow a storyline through all of them and be like, oh my
I was
gosh.
Always wondering, they should have just written their own storyline and had their own series.
several times I've been like in a parking lot, like Target, and I passed by somebody with a Guild shirt, and I said, hey, great shirt. And they just go, thanks. And they just kept on walking.
Oh, no.
I've done that too. Dude, they never walked up to people at cons who were wearing our cosplay from the video. And I'm like, hey, that's a pretty cool outfit. And they're like, oh, thanks. And they left. Yeah. And I'm like, oh. All right. Well.
Oh my God. How many codexes have you seen at conventions? Too?
So many.
So many. So many wonderful. There's a girl named Ginny. I don't know her last name. She makes codex look so much more beautiful than I could ever aspire to. But I've seen so many iterations. I love the ones where people just like draw on a shirt. I mean, that's
yeah.
So well, the reason why, also one of the reasons why I did that was I was so angry that I knew that I don't have the facial features to ever be a superhero on TV or be a lead. So I was like, I'm going to make us superheroes. Okay. And so I was like, we're going to have superhero costumes that people are going to want to wear at conventions. Cause I literally just set out to do that with those outfits.
That's so awesome.
And Sarah Trost, who was on, she's on,
she's amazing.
Project One Way. Wasn't she?
Yeah, she was on Project Runway.
Oh, she was, wasn't she?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So basically, she did an incredible job.
Take a hold on. Take a drink of water. Take a drink of water. It's okay. It's okay. We're all gonna still be here.
Yeah.
I will just say, just picking up a little bit from this story, like that moment, because I remember us being not super, or some of us being like, I don't want to wear this costume.
Comic-Con. I did not.
I'm pretty sure. I didn't want to out you,
Amy. You guys were so bitchy about it.
I was so fucking excited.
Highfalutin actors, and we're just like, I'm wearing blue tights, and I'm like, this is something else.
And I was like, I'm just gonna remind you that like my crotch busted open during the shoot, like, and you want me in real life wearing this thing, and so we were like kind of a little bit not against it, but we're kind of like begrudgingly doing it, and then when we walked out there, like. After that music video played, it was
worth it. For
the
sure.
fan oh, response was absolutely, I mean, just it that is etched deafening. In my memory. Like it was unbelievable. They just the cheers, and then like I felt like the people were flashing like flash bulbs.
Oh, yeah.
I felt like King Kong
anything.
Was like,
yeah, I mean, it was incredible. That was the one where I asked for, that was 2009, I think, and I asked for a bigger room, and Comic-Con only gave us 300 seat room. And there were literally 1,000 people waiting to get into our thing. And from then on, we always got Indigo Ballroom, which holds 5,000.
Awesome.
And I think we sold out every single year. It wasn't until the very, I think we sold out every single year for the Guild. It was just incredible. And the fact that we were pulling more people than an actual TV show who has millions of dollars, guys. And we were still, I'm not kidding. Yeah. It
I still
was
remember
not the Guild.
I remember the show before us was like.
Me too.
Charlie's
no,
in.
No. The show before us was packed, but it was packed with Guild fans that were like staying
seats.
To
right.
see the.
Yeah.
And then when after we did our panel, it just cleared
out.
It
was Charlie's Angels.
Yeah, like it was Charlie's Angels reboot. Yeah, it was.
Was that the
and
show before us or
like,
after
us? After us. Turned out for us.
Because I remember it was like Minka Kelly. It was like famous.
Took a picture with her.
Like sitting that's with hilarious. Like eight people in this in the Indigo Ballroom because the Guild fans cleared out. I was like,
oh my god, I totally remember. I took a picture with Minka Kelly. I was so excited to meet her.
I was like, I don't know who this is, but
and by the way,
come on, she's amazing.
You can buy. I think I remember. I took a picture. Or I have it. The Vork outfit, like you can buy it.
Well,
like,
there's Halloween costumes, right?
Yes, we did get Halloween costumes. Yeah. So early on, like nowadays, it would be so easy to license the show and do so many cool things. My one regret is we never got Funko Pops because it is just feels very, very important to do a Funko Pop, but I guess that's just not going to happen. But back then it was literally nobody had merchandising, y'all. There was no easy way to, there was like Zazzle just started. So we were really a lot earlier than the way that people monetize things nowadays. So it was always very, very tough. And it was always like, well, let's just find somebody who can make us a t-shirt. It was us kind of coming up with an idea that we knew our fans would like, and then just going after it and making it happen versus there being somebody there to actually enable it. And
Jamie Chambers says, I mean, I know a guy who knows a guy.
Chat wants Funko Pops so bad.
I know, a Funko
would
be so
cool.
Great. Well, we tried to get Dr. Horrible Funkos for the 10th anniversary and they turned us down. So I don't
know.
Wow,
what?
Yeah,
that's crazy.
Sadly. Okay.
Dr. Horrible's no Guild.
Well, that's true. Okay, so let's do a little live. We have two little comic readings we're gonna do. They're very
perfect.
Quick.
Okay.
But I just wanted to kind of give you guys just one. We're gonna do one and then take a break, and then we're gonna do the last thing to end up because we still have another hour. We're chatting. So we're gonna do just the first excerpt. Now, if you didn't know, I wrote the Guild comics. I wrote three issues as an origin story for Codex, and then there's another issue two that has an issue for each one of the other characters, five other characters. And the cool thing is that I wrote them with all other people. So the Tink comic, I wrote myself. The Robin comic, I wrote with Clara. The Vince comic, I wrote with Sean Becker.
With Kim
Eby, sorry. And then the Jeff comic I wrote with Jeff, and then the Zabu comic I wrote with Sandeep. So the cool thing is that all of them had a lot of input in their character single stories.
And I think, I hope I'm correct, the Blades you wrote with
Sean,
right.
Yeah. With, I think I said it. Did I?
Oh, did you say that?
You did say that. Yeah.
No, that's okay.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. And so.
I'm sorry. Okay. I'm really sorry.
Listen. It's okay. We don't remember anything.
One more time, Jeff.
I'm sorry.
But the Blades comic was co-written with Sean Becker.
Thank you.
There we go.
So I did not write the comic, Robin comic with Clara. No, that was Kim Evie. That was the one I really screwed up. Thank you. So you could get those either on Kindle or whatever, but we're going to read just a little tiny bit of us, because a lot of them are about, not even about us as a guild. So, I just picked a little section in the Vort comic that Jeff and I wrote just to see kind of how the dynamic worked in the, and the, comics. Cause like I said, most of the comics are about either their families or people we've never even seen in the show, just to give everybody different backstories. So Sean, how are we going to do that? Here we go. Comic reading.
Huzzah.
Are you ready?
Okay, ready? All right, we're going to read off this.
Yeah.
Oh.
A Knights of Good. This is an intro-level dungeon. Why do we keep wiping?
It's you.
Your line. It's still your line.
It's still you. Yeah.
It's, why do we keep wiping?
Well, we skipped a page.
This is going really well.
This is perfect.
Who says Sean, the fire demon?
Listen. That's Sandeep, I think.
You're ahead one
Sandeep,
page.
It's not me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. Sean's looking at the page.
I'm reading off my own. Sorry. I'm reading off.
Oh,
my own.
Me too. Yeah, should we be reading off our own, or should we be reading off the
take
Zoom
two,
one?
Take two.
Oh, we do. We're missing a comic. It's okay. Wait.
I knew.
Rewind.
I'm not crazy. I mean, I'm an
nailed
idiot.
Nailed it,
but I'm not...
you guys.
No, you're
it's
right.
It's just like being on the show again.
It is.
So should I read it? Okay. So it's
no.
I'll
we're missing
wait.
A comic. We're missing the one with the fire and everybody with
the
their weapons out.
The fire demon keeps sending ads.
The fire demon keeps sending ads out there. Hey, Sean is going to be awesome and fix that comic.
He's pretty upset. He's pretty upset that he wasn't credited.
We effed up.
And so,
as usual, it's our fault. And Sean did everything perfectly.
Was there anything that you guys had to do that you didn't want to do other than
never
wear your outfits?
Such a brown nose.
Right? I think we revolted wearing that hat. We kind of pushed back. You
what
remember
hat? The squid hats?
It was a Clara hat that we had. You wanted us to wear at the convention.
Mm. Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Oh, that was again. That was not during shooting. That was at a convention.
Oh, that was during, at a convention.
Oh, what? I was on a dragon for like 12 hours.
You were up there a long time.
Yeah.
And that was
my. I think my balls really. Did not appreciate it.
You had your children,
that's
though.
His guy.
Yeah,
you had already children. Had their children. You didn't
You're
need
right.
them, right?
I didn't need them.
I think, okay, there was never a moment that I was like not willing to do. I loved all the weird stuff. But the one moment that might have been harder, well, I made it harder than it had to be, was when my character met Nathan Fillion and I had to pretend to hyperventilate on camera. And I didn't know there's a way you can fake that. So I just locked my knees and hyperventilated for real, and I passed out.
Oh, I remember you passed out.
Because
you didn't know how to breathe.
That's insane.
You passed out? Like,
I remember that.
But you literally fainted? Like, you hit the
ground? My vision went black, and I had to, like, stumble back onto my ass and, like, recover for a while. And one of the guys, I don't know if he was, like, I don't know if he was a DP or, like, an AD or something, but... he had like been in the army or something. I forget his name. And he came over and was like talking me through it and like trying to get me back.
like smelling salts or something.
It was not good.
It was really fun because for a while, everybody on the convention circuit would see the long lines that we have for fans who wanted to meet us. And they were like, who is that? Like, I remember Dragon
Con. Oh my God.
Yeah.
It was such a long line. And all the actors were like, I don't recognize that. Like that girl.
Yeah.
I still remember our first con. Like, we had a little booth that, and there was no line at all. I mean, it was like, we had 2 hour blocks that each of us would do.
Which one?
Was that Houston?
The very first, no,
oh,
it's the very
God,
first Comic Con.
Do not bring up Delta H Con.
Let's not
don't
talk
you
about
dare.
That.
Dare.
Not, what happens at Delta H Con?
That guy's probably watching right now.
Like, talk about 14 year old Brian.
Yeah.
Huh? Wait, which comic are you talking about?
14-year-old Brian. The San Diego Comic Con, the very first one, we had a small, tiny booth.
We shared it with the Brown Coats, didn't we?
Yes, the Brown Coat booth. Thank you, Brown Coats.
I remember us having a huge line.
No.
Yes.
We had a decent number of people who had gathered, but then we burned through it pretty quickly.
Maybe later on, but that first one, I was just standing there for like...
You were just standing there. Maybe you were just at the wrong booth and you were just standing there.
I like that first one.
Oh God, Jeff, you were in the Charlie's Angels booth.
No.
We definitely had the big lines when we were all together.
Yeah.
That was...
For sure, yeah.
Do you remember when we were... I think it was...
not the size of the line.
It was Dragon Con, and we were waiting to go up in the elevator, and Norman Reedus... I'll never forget this in my entire life because I love him. Norman Reedus. He's on...
Walking Dead.
Walking Dead and Boondock Saints.
Yeah. So he's
standing next to us, and I look over and I'm like, oh, play it cool, Robin. And he's like, hey, you guys had a big line today. What show are you on? Because I don't know if Walking Dead just came out or he was doing something for Boondock Saints, and he didn't really have a line. And we were like, oh, it's this web series called The Guild. And he's like, oh, cool. I'm going to have to check that out. And I was like, it's Norman Reedus. And then he goes in and Amy looks at me and is like, who's that? And I was like,
I was
Amy.
I did the same thing just
worst
now.
Wing woman ever.
Yeah. It was so good.
Who's that?
I never knew anybody at the conventions except Rick Fox.
Yes, I was going to say, you lost your shit for Rick Fox.
You were the one person
that I was like, oh, Amy actually is impressed with somebody I've gotten to guest star on.
And Rick Fox is the one person who I had no idea who that was.
And you didn't tell me you got him. And I didn't find out until like he was already gone. I wasn't on set that day and I literally cried.
I remember, I forgot about that.
I remember you crying at lunch.
Yeah.
You cried because you couldn't meet Rick Fox, but you met him later because he came to the party.
Someone kept meeting him at like random things. Like it happened like four times and people would keep sending me photos.
It was Sandeep. He just would run into Rick Fox everywhere.
Like I think we all started doing it.
Yeah, everyone kept sending me photos and I finally met him at Dragon Con and I lost it. I was like bawling.
And then I feel like he took a video and was like, hey, Amy, sorry you missed
it. Yeah, you got him to do that.
It's so funny.
It's because you guys would always go to these like Comic-Con parties, but I like never really went to like the really late parties and you guys like kept running into him and stuff. And
yeah, it's okay.
Man, I couldn't drink until the guild ended.
Yeah, that's true. You couldn't.
True.
We would not let you drink. How does Vince's sister feel about her time on the guild? Is she in therapy for it or what's going on?
Oh, we ruined her. No, she really enjoyed it. She had a really good time. Hilarious. She's not an actor by any measure. She's a scientist now. She's pursuing her PhD.
Are you kidding? She's so smart. That's amazing.
The best deadpan I've ever seen. She's the best deadpan.
The thing though is, she's like that in real life. That's exactly what she is like in reality.
Is she still like that? Is she still like that?
100%. 100%. Like that dry deadpan that's 100% Tara. Oh,
that was one of the comics that I wrote for the extra. So if you guys go to Dark Horse, there's a hardback compilation that came out a couple years ago for, I think it was the 10th anniversary. It might've been 4 years ago. Yeah, it was because I was writing it when I was pregnant because I had nothing else to do. So I wrote like, they only wanted 4 new pages and I wrote 34 and they're like, we can't pay you because you wrote too much. But if we don't pay you, we can pay the artist to actually get the art for these pages. I was like, great. So there is a Dina comic in there, which is really funny, of her being like a neighborhood detective that makes me laugh a lot.
I love it.
I would love to have Tara on the stream. Okay. So let's do the comic. Sean is ready, and we're going to have a redo of that.
Okay. Are we ready?
Gotta get my blades ready. Here we go.
Okay. Knights of Good. This is an entry level dungeon. Why do we keep wiping?
And it's way too small for me to read.
Okay, you
can
just
pull
read it
up on your own computer, my dude.
I'm going to. I'm doing it right now. My bad.
All right, back to one.
Back to one.
Oh my God.
Knights of
one.
Good. This is
back
an
to
inch.
One.
Okay. I'm taking a deep breath.
Okay.
All right. Nailed this one.
Knights of Good. This is an entry level dungeon. Why do we keep wiping?
Well, the fire demon keeps sending ads out there that are frying our DPS.
I don't need a reason. That was a rhetorical statement. We've been playing together for 104 game hours. We should be working as a cohesive unit.
My unit's cohesive. Want me to work it?
We just started this guild. We're not going to go pro overnight. Take a chill pill. Jeez.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm having fun.
Well, you're wrong. Zabu, on this attempt, use your minions to kite the two in center. You're not managing your resources properly. Kodak, start using mending hands before damage starts, not after. And Clara, you need to respec elemental expertise to use water wind armor.
But I don't look cute in that.
Bork, it's great you're giving us advice.
And by great, she means it's totally effed up.
But I think we can manage our own spell choices.
Codex, when I want your input, I will submit an in-game chat room help request.
Okay.
And Blades, I need you to... Where's Blades?
Barbecue times!
Blades!
We need some more Blades.
Come on,
Blades.
Do it bigger. Come bigger.
Go for it. Blades!
There it is. There's our take. Check the game. We're moving on.
Oh, so good.
I think the burning to death line is yours, Zabu.
Dark Source shot it.
Perfect interpretation of that.
Screw this. Can we do the Tanger Green Dungeon instead?
Absolutely not. That is not scheduled until the week from Thursday at 2:30.
2:30.
Hold up. You made us a beep 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 schedule.
A beep beep beep.
Yeah, there we go.
The one take wonders. Do it again.
Yeah, we did it.
I'm really glad that you got the tooth hurdy joke. That
tooth
was
hurdy.
Tooth hurdy joke.
That's one of my favorite jokes.
I've heard you say that about 200 times, Jeff.
It never goes out of style.
You make some good points.
I laugh every time. Yes! Oh, I can't overstate it.
Beepaw asks, will the show ever be available to buy digitally? Beepaw, I believe it's available on iTunes to buy. It was on Netflix for literally almost 10 years, y'all. We were one of the first licensed thing on Netflix. They just kept re-upping it, but they decided not to renew it this last year, I think because they kind of stopped doing licensed content. I don't even know. It made
They'll
me sad. But I am talking with other people to maybe license it. The first four seasons are available on YouTube right now, only as individual episodes. I have not uploaded the rest because I do have other people who are kind of wanting to license it. If by the end of the year nothing happens, I will put it just a whole, you know, I'll put all the episodes up on YouTube for people to watch. But the only way you can get the whole movies and things like that right now is through the DVD, or I think you could buy the individual episodes on iTunes, or if you have a Zune, strangely, you could still get them for free because of our licensing agreement.
Nice. Y'all get
on
that
Zune train.
Us to
do these
readings
of it. We're so good at it.
It's true.
Yeah.
The DVDs do have great extra content. They have like so much behind the scenes videos that you can't get anywhere else.
Original auditions.
Can I say the director's cut, the actor's commentary tracks were always so
fun.
Oh yeah, that was really fun. Those were a good time.
Yeah, we had a lot of memories.
Really but fun. With like 2 minute gaps once in a while where we just stop and watch the episode silently.
Forgot we're supposed to talk.
I just want to urge everybody, if you want to support the show, we have t-shirts that are available that are $12 right now. They're on half price. If you want to grab a guild shirt, they're really good. And not the one that's on Jeff Lewis, but the rock and roll one.
Jeff's confusingly showing off.
And if you would like to get the DVDs, you can always get those on Amazon. But the biggest thing you could do is follow and or sub to all of our channels. All of us are streaming right now. We're all really into it and we play together, but also individually we all have really good time. I think, what do you guys do together? You guys do Jars, right, Jeff?
Yeah.
Robin, Amy?
Fortnite.
And it's Sean, yeah. Fun,
yeah. What nights do you play that?
Really? Tuesday?
Tuesday, yeah.
Well, not tonight, but.
Tuesday nights, yeah, but normally on Tuesday.
Well, maybe
night,
later.
And sometimes Friday.
Maybe later.
I thought we were playing later, but maybe not. I guess it's news to you.
No.
That's weird. I guess I've just been informed of that.
Sandeep, when do you, what are your main things that you stream on, and when can people watch you?
Usually on Tuesdays during the day, I stream from 3 to 6-ish, and usually do like an interview show. I've been taking a break from interviews, but it's been fun to have like actors and scientists and other interesting people to interview. I love doing that. But lately I've just been playing with Adam Catino. We've been playing Gauntlet, the old dungeon runner.
Oh my god.
It's super fun. It's super fun. There's like a newer version of it, not the like arcade game version. Mm-hmm. That one's been a blast.
That's really fun. Vince, where can people find you every single day playing Among Us?
Among Us is usually maybe once a week for me these days.
Wait, what?
I'm usually streaming. I'm trying to slowly phase it out.
Why though? I mean, you're so...
It's the best game ever.
Honestly,
He's waiting for his
I
burned out on it a little while ago. Although there's some new mods that are like fun to ground once in a while, but like it's just, it's a lot of one game. So these days I stream like usually Monday, Wednesday, Thursday around 5 to 8 p.m. PDT. Wow. Playing Dead by Daylight, Fortnite, Among Us, a couple other games here and there, usually with other like content creator friends and with some guildies once in a while. So that's always, you know, always a good time.
Yeah.
Is anybody still no pixeling, or is that?
No.
Nobody's
no. A lot of people have not.
I don't. I gotta be honest. I don't really enjoy the GTA stuff that much.
Yeah.
And there's been some drama and BS, and it's all just
yeah.
Moving on to other stuff.
Drama. Yeah, I enjoyed it while it was. We had a big good game going on there. So
yeah,
on Sunday
it was fun
nights,
for a while.
At the last Sunday of every month, we actually play D&D together. And before that, we play some group games. So Sunday nights, you could tune into that. And I stream several times a week. You can always find that here on my schedules. Okay, what can
I
can
also
about?
Clarify it real fast because people in chat are already roasting me about it. I also do DM a D&D show on Friday nights on the Pixel Circus Twitch channel. I really should mention that.
Yes, you should.
It's doing very well, actually. It's a very, very successful show so far. We just had a big old front page episode, a wedding episode for two of our characters. They got like, 12,000 views. So it's a great show, worth checking out on Pixel Circus. And I'm also looking to bring more D&D content onto my channel as well pretty soon. So
great, awesome.
Check that out.
Carmelux asks, can we talk about Will Wheaton's impact on the series? I mean,
did Jeff say no?
No,
it was great. He was awesome.
He's not here. So let's not talk about him. Is that what?
No, I didn't say no. Don't do that.
I heard no.
I said I didn't say no, but let's not talk about him.
He was amazing. I remember. My friend Kim Evie did sketch classes with him at Acme, which is a place that Jeff and I did a lot of, that's where I actually met Kim Evie. She was my sketch writing teacher. It was the only writing class I ever took. And that's how I met her. And I got into this women's support group called Chicken. And that led to me being guilted into writing a script for the guild and two of the other women helping me make it, which was just an awesome experience. But at Acme, she did, So when I was writing in at Rival Guild Leader, she's like, I think Will Wheaton should play this. I was like, and I was like a Star Trek Next Generation. Like, I was in love with Riker, like absolutely in love with him as like an 8-year-old. So I was like, he's touched Riker. So I was so excited that I would meet him. So I remember I took him to this brand new coffee shop in Silver Lake where they had, it was LA Mill, and they had $8 coffee. And I was like, this is ridiculous, but I'm going to wine and dine him because I don't drink. So basically Don't drink coffee. Exactly. I mean, at the time I did drink, but I didn't drink that much. I didn't want to take him out to a bar. So I took him out to $8 coffee and I knew we were going to get along, but cause he's like, at the end, he's like, yeah, I'd love to do it. Can you believe this coffee is $8?
We had a lot of fun doing scenes at Amalfi, Will and the Guild.
Yeah. That place is torn down now. The place that we shot, one of my neighbors owned that place. Well, not neighbors, but just a person who used to own Acme. Yeah.
I just will never forget the big bug.
Oh my God, those scarab beetles.
Wait,
oh my God, yes.
The big bug?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
It's an outtake.
Wait, okay, so one of the cast literally just reached out and just grabbed it and held it. Who was that?
Wasn't that?
It was Teddy.
Teddy.
Was that Teddy?
It was Teddy, yeah, right? He just went like this. It was a June bug.
Massive freaking beetle. Just like that.
It was the green beetle.
It was a huge beetle.
Scarab beetle.
Scarab, yeah.
Scarab,
yeah.
It was some straight up Miyagi
he
stuff.
He screamed
like,
adorably.
Which was hilarious. Yeah. Outside GameStop.
Yeah.
Outside the GameStop. Yeah. That's exactly right.
Which, gosh, to wish we bought stock back then, huh, guys?
I know. Come on.
Topical.
Foamy Evening asks, can you please ask Jeff if he will ever re-upload 5-minute comedy hour videos? What happened?
Is it not
upload?
Is it
upload what?
5-minute comedy hour.
Your 5-minute video, comedy hour. Where are those videos?
They're all up somewhere. I don't know where. I mean,
we've misplaced them.
They're on YouTube, I assume.
Have we tried searching? Have we tried searching?
Has anybody tried searching?
No, but I'll look into it. I don't know what.
Have you ever asked Matt Mercer to come DM for you? Kind of like you owe me for critical. No, I would never do that, first of all. Second of all, yeah, that would be fun if Matt came and DM, but I'd always assume he's really busy. But,
oh, you should hit him up, though. It'd be fun.
I'm very shy when it comes to people who I know are busy.
Yeah, it's weird. I went ahead and searched for it in YouTube and I found them all. I found all the. I typed in Jeff Lewis 5-minute comedy hour and then there's 20.
I'm not sure what's yeah, they're there, right? I mean,
they're there. So this person was a little maybe not understanding that. A lot of them are gone now, says Foamy Evening. Okay.
Oh, maybe a lot of them are missing or something, but it's, you have a 5-minute hour.
So why are they down? Did somebody do DMCA on them and they're just not available?
It may have to do with, we sold some rights to a French company.
Oh.
What?
And a French company? Maybe some of them are missing for that. I don't know.
You're famous in France?
French.
Dude,
did you say
Jeff,
French
I want to see
French?
Tag with a French dub. I really do.
I think it's the same time. I think it was the same time the guild would, that they, the same company or something like that. But I don't know why, actually. I have no idea
why. Mr. Lewis. Wow.
I don't know why they're missing. It's a good question.
All right. Have you ever considered doing an animation version of the Guild? David Mello, I did actually pitch two people an animated version of the Guild. They did not get it. One of the people, okay, I'm not going to out this company. They are a famous company. They're actually
just
a production company. And they were, so they, I pitched them this, and I got the whole deck together, and I pitched it, and they, after 3 weeks, we're like, no, this isn't for us. Here's the deck on what we're looking for. Oh, and they gave me the deck and I looked at it and they were like, we really want gaming content. We want humor. We want somebody some kind of IP driven thing. Literally what they were looking
for. It's the Guild.
The Guild. And I literally.
Middle-aged guy.
Yeah, bald middle-aged guy named Jeff Lewis. So they turned the show down and yet they sent me a deck that literally had the Guild in it. And I've never been so YOLO in my life. And I'm like, actually what you're looking for is the Guild and you just passed on it. Have a good day.
Ooh, that was good.
What you should have done is actually, you know what? I have the perfect thing. And then just resubmit the Guild.
Yeah, exactly.
Yep.
Yeah.
How about this?
Yeah.
Wow.
So anyway, and then I just didn't repitch it. So, you know, it would be nice to do something with the show, but I have to tell you that Hollywood has stomped on my heart so many times. I don't know if I have the strength to go back in again. I just want to be honest with you.
I'm sorry. Oh, bless.
That's okay. I get to do what I want, and I get to stream and get to do things outside the box, and that's cool. And nice. I get to spend time with my friends. That's all. Everyone says that somebody said I was in Owl House, and my daughter is a big Owl House fan. Oh, that's really nice. Hi. Thank you so much. What about audiobook visions of the... Okay, so audiobook versions of the Guild comics. Hazy Hoot. Actually, after putting this together, I was thinking maybe we'll do like a one-off evening, like a special like... kind of like a theater reading of the other Guild comics, like all of them together.
Yeah.
If you guys would be interested in that,
that'd
let
be
me
fun,
know.
Yeah.
Because we might just, you know, we could do a more professional version of.
I'll learn my lines.
Yeah, everyone will learn their lines. Yeah. I have some questions. What on Netflix? Ooh. When about Glitch Techs? Oh, that's interesting.
Oh, Glitch Techs.
Yeah, Sandeep and I actually read, we worked on that show. It was really good.
We did. I was a writer on it, and Felicia basically made the intro and got me the gig, and at least got me the interview. I did pull off that interview quite nicely, and got to work on it for the two seasons that were, and got to voice a character, and then Felicia got to voice a character.
I did a few lines, but I was cut out.
Why did you get cut out, Jeff?
Really?
It was too good.
That's showbiz, baby.
You got cut out? Oh.
I did. No, can really I say sucks. One thing? Yeah. Can I go back to one thing? I'm sorry.
Yes.
When you mentioned limes, I remember after season one, I think you had a PA exclusively there just to run limes with us. I can't, because there was some, I don't know.
Well,
I
guess also, like Jeff, you in particular, Felicia kept giving you these freaking monologues in it's every true. Scene.
Which was on the always on the monitor. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I could not possibly.
Listen, I've been on many a professional set. That they do that there too. Okay. Yeah, don't worry about it.
Yeah. I watched the Friends reunion and they talked about how they hid their lines around the set. Uh-huh. I remember that. And I was like, see, we're not the only jerks that did that.
Yep. Exactly.
But that's kind of your fault for hiring improvisers.
Yeah.
It's true.
Oh,
and
yeah,
also,
so much of the show
would,
made up.
I will have to tell you, I rewrote to the second, like, I would rewrite whole scenes and give people brand new sides on the morning. And Sadiq and Jeff and I, as particularly, would do. Sometimes we'd like rewrite a whole scene before we shot it because it wasn't as funny as it could have been. And they are hilarious improvisers and writers. And we definitely would polish, or at the very least polish, scenes before we went on and make up, like that shirt you're wearing, Jeff, you made up that line, women can't live without,
oh yes,
can't live with them. They will not go out with me. And you actually did that.
Oh, you improvised at the table read, I think. And
no, we had a scene and you had never played poker before and you had a scene that was completely wrong, like, this is not how anybody plays poker.
Yeah.
that's right
and we said we got to replace this, so it was like middle of the night and we're like, we have to replace this because Felicia has no idea what poker is.
I remember that clearly.
I can't say go fish once.
In the middle of this scene.
Like, what is she doing? I don't understand.
Yeah. 15th anniversary reunion at San Diego Comic-Con. That would be amazing.
Wow.
Because
be
it would be really rad. We did a 10th anniversary there, and it was so fun.
That's fun.
Were you still in touch pre-pandemic, or did the pandemic reunite the guild? That's a good question.
It kind of reunited us, didn't it? I mean, like,
yeah.
I mean, as a group, I feel like it did, but I don't know.
Well, we were in touch the whole time, but I think what kind of kicked this off is, Felicia, you hit us up to do D&D live.
Yeah.
We were going to do D&D in an actual theater, and then the pandemic hit, and that turned into, let's do a run on Zoom online, and then that snowballed everything else from there.
We were going to do a weekly at the typewriter, not electric
the
typewriter.
Dynasty typewriter?
But, yes, the Dynasty typewriter. They wanted to do something. I was like, what if we come in every Sunday and do live D&D? And I'm like, that would be fun. And we were going to do that. And then the pandemic literally hit the month we were going to schedule it.
Oh, yeah. The month.
Yeah.
We did go to a lot of cons, so we saw each other.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And for like big stuff, right? Like weddings, baby showers, stuff like that.
Yeah, we haven't had any, like, we haven't seen each other in years, but certainly this is like more friendly and like more.
You guys, though, for real, for the 15th anniversary of the guild, which is next year, I will be 30 years old.
Oh,
meaning the guild will have been half of my life.
Oh, my
that's
so
insane.
Wow.
I think we should ask Microsoft to see if they'll throw you a 30th birthday party.
Yes, please. Let's bring it all back. I want the bus with the pole, baby. Come on.
Oh, my God.
Okay, this is a good... Abby Day Y is asking a really good question. In the guild AU, where the characters are Olympians, what would their sports be? So in the guild alternate universe...
Oh, my God.
What would your sport be in the guild alternate universe where you were? What is the Sandeep channel? I can't find it. I don't want to tell. It's You guys can, if you just mouse over the video, there is a pop-up, and on the bottom, there are buttons, and you can automatically follow everybody.
Buttons.
Robin says it like me too, okay?
It's just you too.
Just because you two say it doesn't mean it's right.
Yeah, so you can follow everybody and support them on their channels. They would love it.
Okay, Olympic sports.
Yeah, what would your Olympic sport be?
Oh my God.
Probably competitive accounting.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. Probably like beer pong for Clara, or like cornhole or whatever that game is.
Cornhole?
Isn't that what that's called?
Yes, it is. I'm
okay.
It has many definitions.
Does it, Jay?
I feel like Blades would have wanted to be like an Olympic snowboarder or something, and he would have tried out once and not even qualified for county. or what have you. And at this point, I have to get water for the athletes. Like, there's no way that Blade's actually doing well at it.
No. I could see Amy.
I feel like, I feel like I'd be something that, like, requires, like, a lot of, like, aggression. Like, like a martial arts or something.
Judo or something.
Yeah,
Taekwondo
fencing.
All day.
Something like that.
Olympic archery.
Archery is a little tame, though. You know,
I'm trying to think of what the creepiest and also Olympic South Korea wins for every year. I can't think
of it. There's creepy ones. I mean, like, curling's kind of creepy, right?
Yeah, but
curling's
like
kind of creepy. What a hot take.
Curling's fun. Curling would be a guild, stalkery like a sport. For all of us.
Olympic hide and seek. I don't know.
God. Into table tennis. I think you would definitely be table tennis. And actually, table tennis is super hot if you watch people do it really well. I think you watch speed walking is the creepiest. 100%.
Speed walking. Well, like, kind of the biathlon. I feel like that one's weird.
Yeah,
biathlon. That's what Tal Bernard said. Yeah.
What's a biathlon?
It's when you cross country ski and then also shoot. I feel like it's the weirdest combination.
Do you swim too, or is just cross country? And
no, it's just, it's bi, so it's two. Cross-country skiing and marksmanship.
How do they just pick those two things together? Oh, no. Why is that?
I feel like they watched a James Bond film and they were like, that should be an Olympic sport.
That's insane.
Someone skiing and shooting.
I don't feel like Codex would have any skills whatsoever. She would probably be in the orchestra just playing any kind of like for the opening ceremonies. And yet a firework would errantly stray and blow up her and her violin.
Yes.
So she'd run around and become like a meme because she's screaming. Ooh,
Equestrian.
Okay.
Codex
okay.
on a horse. Come on.
I buy that. Yeah.
All right. I'll get you that one. We have 20 more minutes, guys. Get your questions in. What would be a good setting for a guild Lego set? Ooh, okay, bricks.
Oh my
That's a great question.
While you're thinking of it, this is a nice comment. The guild was incredibly impactful in my life. It got me through so many tough times, and I really connected with each character in their own special way. So I wanted to share a deep well of gratitude.
That's really sweet.
I'd love to see a Cheesy Beards Lego set.
Cheesy Beard. It has to be Cheesy Beards.
That's a good one.
The Lego pizza.
With part of it like burning
cheesy
down.
Beards.
I feel like Vork's apartment, like with the squab.
That's true.
The squab.
The cages and
Daddy's doghouse. Daddy's doghouse. Vork's van.
Oh yeah, the van. Oh my gosh, the van would be hilarious. But make it like Barbie size. You know how like Barbie has the like Winnebago? It'd be like.
I'm surprised nobody's done that. Like
the
a Lego.
That would be so hilarious.
The van is the Millennium Falcon of the show for sure.
Oh my God. Yeah.
I wanted to share a little. I don't know if you guys remember season 4. We had an amazing actor play the owner of Cheesy Beards. And
oh, he
Blades.
Was great.
He was so funny. But the set for The Office.
Who was that?
Was built in a person's house. And Greg Aronowitz, I have to give him a shout out. He is a demented genius when it comes to building things that are. Inappropriate for where they are. Like, so in his actual living room, he built a set for, it was literally a box inside a person's living room so we could have a set to shoot Ollie's office. His character was Ollie. And it was so hot, but we were in a person's house.
So
and I just-
who was the actor?
His, Ollie, what is his name? I'm so sorry.
I know you're talking about, I remember.
He's wonderful, he's wonderful. And now I'm looking it up, IMDb. He worked a lot. He was on Frank Ashmore. That was it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Frank Ashmore. What's he doing
Frankie.
Right now?
Character
actor.
Frank Ashmore. He was so funny. And I had had, I literally had a nervous breakdown during, because.
Which one?
Which one?
I know.
Okay.
That's like in every story that you
that
have.
That was phase one. Yeah. So he was in Airplane, by the way.
That's
you guys.
So rad. I
Can you believe that?
That is awesome.
Yeah, that's really cool.
So yeah, I had a real nervous breakdown. There was one after Geek & Sundry started that was probably the most impactful that I'm still recovering from. But I had one after season 3 because the show was so successful. I put so much pressure on myself it was just hard for me. I was like, oh my gosh, how am I going to top this? And so I had such horrible writer's block and I really never liked anything I wrote for season 4. And thank God for Vince Casso and Frank to made that Cheesy Beards. I delighted in all. And there were some effects that Sean as a director did that made those so much funnier than it was on the page. And I just want to give a shout out to filmmaking in general, it's a collaborative process and everybody makes it better than the writer puts it on the page. So I just want to thank all of you for being that wonderful.
Yeah, it was a great time. I love sneezing on burgers any day of the week.
That was gross. Also, Frank was in Arrested Development in 2018.
Mm. How fun.
So who played? Oh my God, Mike Rose. I love Mike Sandeep's Rose. Sandeep's mom. Oh, you did.
He was also Sandeep. Sandeep's mom.
I love Mike Rose.
Someone was asking who the crossover from Legend of Neil and the guild was, and I think they were thinking of Mike Rose.
Oh, Mike Rose.
Though Mike Jeff Rose also played a part.
It's probably the funniest. What line did he say that I still say? Oh, your breath is hot. When he says that,
your breath is hot. Was his character name Fox? Oh wait, was that Will Wheaton's character?
That was Will Wheaton.
Fox was it?
What was Mike's character?
I can't remember. He worked at like.
Chat says he played Valkyrie.
Valkyrie,
that's right.
No, I thought that was
right.
Oh
yeah,
that sounds right.
I thought that was that Teddy guy.
Teddy was Bruiser.
Bruiser
and Teal.
And he banged my mom.
Played Venom.
VG Nathan played
Venom. Got it.
VG Nathan is so good. And also, I want to give a shout out to Michelle Boyd, who is she's a Twitch streamer as well. And she played Stupid Hot Girl, Riley.
Stupid Tall Hot Girl.
That's really so funny.
I stream with her pretty much every week.
Oh, you
and
do?
We've had her once or twice on the Guild Game Nights, too.
We have on Guild Game Nights on Sunday.
Yeah, I play with her all the time.
Nice. Yeah, the whole... The whole Axis of Anarchy was so awesome. I did actually a one shot with Will Wheaton. I wrote a one shot for Fox. And it's so fun when you write with an actor who plays the character. They bring so much. Like when I wrote with Jeff and Sandeep and Sean, like when you write for somebody else who has a different perspective on the character, you really learn a lot as an actor. Because I didn't have any backstories for any of those characters. And so when I started the comic, it was like, I don't know where Codex is from. I have no idea. So I had to make all of it up for the comic. But after that, it was so much easier to play her because you kind of know where there's... That's what real actors do, you guys. Do backstory. Yeah. I didn't do that.
Yeah. I understand that.
Later.
Let's see. Where do you think the guild would be in a revival episode? Well, that's a good segue into one of our last segments, you guys. We're going to do this last comic reading and then we'll take a couple more questions and then we will be on our merry way. But this is a really good one. So this is a one shot that I did. It's 4 pages, so it's a little bit longer than the last one. And it is, let's just read it. Okay.
It starts with, wait, what is it?
Yeah. It starts on Robin's line.
Okay. Yeah. Got it.
Okay. It starts on Robin.
Does it? Where?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Oh, yes. Okay. Sorry. Get me down. The perspective from up here is too much in VR. I might puke.
Must I remind you again to stay in the back as a spellcaster?
Stuff it and take a screenshot. I feel like this looks iconic.
Open fire on Zombie Prince Kang with all your forceness.
Not a word.
It is when you're losing. We're losing.
Well, my reflexes are not what they used to be.
You should take... Oh, I forgot what this was. You told me what it was.
CoQ10.
You should take CoQ10 Codex. Kill shot, yes.
Robin?
Yeah.
We're missing a page.
Oh, are we? Oh, no, not again.
Well, just we can just go...
There you go.
Okay. falling seriously, almost puking.
Oof, sheesh, that was pretty close to a wipe.
Next time, we'll down him faster.
Unlikely, since we can't seem to coordinate better after 30 years.
And now a preview of the exciting new reboot of your favorite show.
Tink, you were very distracted during that fight.
Older.
Sorry, Waylee interrupted me. We have tandem massages at 4 p.m.
Waylee, which husband is that, Tink?
Oh, he's just a lover I took after my husband 5. No. 6? Yeah, whatever.
Sorry to ask, but can we reschedule the next raid? My assistants are trying to squeeze in a trip to the White House next week. So.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Wait, I'm free Tuesday afternoon and Thursday after 6 p.m., right, team?
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You inventing edgy things for babies and creating a Fortune 500 company could be this taxing on my shit.
No can do Thursday night. My band's playing. Anyone want to pop in and watch? Man. I can totally put you on the list if you want.
Oh, he's just a meth head. Got it.
He's become a meth head.
Oh my God.
Sounds fun, Blades. My schedule is free for anything, as usual. It's a long trip to Mars. I don't get booked up a lot. I'll project myself down there. Save a seat for me, okay?
I'll come too, Blades. We should support each other's work, guys. Is it an open mic? Maybe I can play a few songs from my violin album.
No, it's pre-booked.
Ah, darn. And all the streaming revenue goes to support my cat rescue shelter, too.
We know.
Enough socializing. Raid next week, Tuesday, 4 p.m. Thursday. Wait. We will tolerate watching Blade show. For the record, I will order nothing and pay no cover.
Awesome. So can we split up the loot already?
Too much. Oh, we still have to do that?
Whatever.
Oh, after all these years, meh.
Cheesy Beards tribute band night,
half off draft.
I wonder if it's too late to go back and graduate.
FYI, there's some solar flares happening, so I might have to blip in. I might blip in and out a bit.
Someone hook up my other oxygen tank. The lack of talent in here is making it hard to breathe.
I could get my violin, do a cover of something about cats, maybe Cat Scratch Fever.
Jeez.
No.
Golden Guild, coming soon to a comic store near you.
Good old, my God,
that was so much fun.
I'm sorry. Hey, Sean, can you go back to that one page that has everybody but me yelling at me? We know, because I just want to
That's a great shot. That's an amazing still.
It is an amazing still of everybody in the future.
We know.
Tink has had a lot of plastic surgery.
Those liver spots.
There's a constellation.
There's a solid two of us who look like total garbage, and everyone else looks great.
I mean, you are definitely a meth addict.
I'm awful. Look at me. What 100% happened?
Breaking bad.
I was running a
mommy blog for Clara, and then this happened.
Oh my gosh.
And Tink got like six husbands, but she's like, you know, in the Caribbean, so she's clearly done well for herself.
Yeah.
All the Botox.
All of
it. My boobs got so much bigger.
I know, 32
you got
boobs
up.
Huge.
Also, Vork is in a little scooter, because I was like, for sure he's got to be in a little scooter.
He's like 90. Yeah.
What do they call it, rascal?
Yeah. Little rascal. And Zabu is literally going to Mars.
I've aged gracefully.
Oh my God, what?
Oh my God. Oh my
Burgers ahoy! Want to know why my Roger is so jolly? Come on down to Cheesy Beards for all your pirate burger needs.
Serving decent food for many years, Cheesy Beards has something special, everyone.
Like our below deck burger served with a side of cucumber. The soggy dog.
That's so good.
Scurvy fries kid salad special with dessert fries.
Enjoy.
Wow, Cheesy Beards really knows how to serve it up.
These competitors can walk the plank, not overboard. So don't settle for shark bait. Walk the plank down to Cheesy Beards and taste. Taste my pirate patty.
Cheesy Beards.
Oh my God.
Okay.
Wow.
Y'all, the last time someone asked me to say that line was less than a year ago.
That's gonna stick with you forever, man.
Actually, that's one of the questions people ask. Does anybody have a catchphrase or anything that they ask you to do? People ask me to sing Date My Avatar, which you can do with a channel point thing.
I do know cheese thing. Gouging.
Yeah. Oh, that's a great one. Yeah.
Apostrophe D thing. So like university or something like that for
which Amy, came from Ryan Day, didn't it? Originally, that's how it was inspired.
It was my brother who would text me on AOL Messenger, and he would always do apostrophe D on everything when we would talk on AOL Messenger back in the early 2000s. And so I just gave that to AOL Messenger. Yeah, I gave that to him. It was inspired by my brother, nice, who Vince. Was an extra. And if you get the DVDs, there is a video. I think it's an Easter egg hidden on one of the pages where it just. Shots of my brother looking in the camera because he didn't know how to not look in the camera when
I
you were
love
filming.
That. Oh my god.
That's funny. Turbo
yes,
just
plus
from...
five to sexterity. I get that one too.
Oh, that's a great one.
Oh, that is good.
Which also made it onto a t-shirt.
That was an improv line.
Did improvise that.
Yep. I give you credit. I love seeing you all together again playing Among Us. I did. I said it.
No, yeah, but did Sean write the Blades thing or not?
Just to make sure.
For the comic? No, I wrote that solo. Okay, I love seeing you guys together again, playing Among Us in the streams. Are you all planning on producing any other content together? Well, we do D&D monthly.
Yeah.
I mean, and we play group games. And as far as doing another season, I would hate to do a Kickstarter or something and have us not make it. Web video is a weird place.
It's true. I mean, you know we would, but.
I don't know. I don't know how, well, quite frankly, I don't know how we would shoot it for the price, like anywhere near the price that we did. Like, you know, just we paid people as much as we possibly could, but it was a fraction of what an indie movie usually costs.
If anybody's going to beat Crit Roll's Kickstarter, it's going to be us.
Some of us do Hammer. Hammer Don't Hurt Him.
Yeah, we do improv sometimes together.
We have an improv show, yeah.
Yeah, paying for Jeff Lewis alone would be...
Yeah, Jeff has gotten very expensive, according to chat.
It's true. Too much, yeah. My rate's gone way up, yeah.
I don't even know where we'd release it, you guys. Like, we wouldn't want to put it on YouTube. Nobody watches videos on YouTube anymore. Like, anyway, well, we'll see. If I had an idea...
Maybe a play.
Maybe.
I'm thinking Broadway.
Let's do a musical.
That'd be fun.
Off Broadway.
Quibi would not take a meeting. That was me.
On Quibi.
Quibi. Exist, my so God.
And look what happened.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah. If they had the guild, they'd still be around.
We should be on OnlyFans. That's what they say. Okay.
We could pull it off. We could pull it off.
What do you use?
The guild, but feet.
Vine.
Vine.
Do you all feel that you've grown more geeky since the guild or less, says Nina Jaden?
More.
And we're wrapping
definitely
it up, guys.
More.
So we only have a couple more minutes.
Definitely more.
I read that pilot, I had never played World of Warcraft, and I went home, and that began. I have to tell you, I played one afternoon. And my wife said, "If you play one more afternoon, we are through." I was playing like all day and night. The minute after I came home, it started this.
It hooks you.
And
it
you're really like, "This does. Is my work, honey.
I'm a method actor, okay?
She's the one who wanted you to do the guild."
No, legit, right. The show is this what is got me fault. Into WoW and then got me, honestly, down the whole just chain, ultimately into PC gaming, which is like, you know, that's streaming now. So I definitely think it got me more nerdy than less, for sure.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The guild almost killed
got
Jeff
nerdier.
Snurge.
Yep. Amy.
I mean, we're jars for crying out loud.
Yeah, But I honestly, I feel like it's less the guild and more like my husband, but not, you know, I love you all.
Okay, we didn't influence you at all.
No.
Let's be
all right,
clear.
Well, that's fine.
Thanks, Amy.
But Mitchell, but you only were with Mitchell because of
the guild.
We gave you Mitchell.
So it's all, it's
we
all.
Made
we gave
you
Mitchell.
Yeah. You re-met him.
You made us. Oh my Jesus!
We brought you into this world. We can take you out.
I think Robin and I weren't. We were like the least nerdy ones,
definitely.
Yeah,
but now when Robin. I'm sorry.
Now you're
Robin
both streaming.
And you on Fortnite. It is like
she kills. Yeah,
yeah.
Unless I headshot her while she's trying to heal Sandeep.
Well, you know.
Yeah, I think I got less nerdy or something. Potentially.
You did, Sandeep? Because you were very nerdy because Sandeep does an amazing, there's another show called Legend of Neil that he did. It was actually doing it at the same time as the Guild and it's very funny and it's about, it's like a really racy Legend of Zelda parody kind of thing. he did a musical. It's like really, really fun. But you were doing that before. Did you do Legend of Neil before the Guild, or was it
before
after?
The Guild? It was for Channel 101.
Channel 101. That's it.
And
you were an empty stage still.
What's yeah, empty stage.
Yeah, well, yeah.
I mean, yeah, a lot of like my joining the Guild was trying to pay Felicia back for acting in my stupid Channel 101 skits for nothing.
Yeah, I remember standing in the backyard. I had to play an alien or something, and
on Blood Oath of Three Men and a Baby.
Blood Oath of Three Men and a Baby. That's it. That was
played
really
an alien that ate children.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty great.
Yeah,
pretty.
Her breakout role.
There were so many great things.
It's really what started it all.
Y'all, I want to just give a shout out. One last shout out to everybody as we're wrapping this up. Everybody here. They stream, and you can easily follow everybody on screen and behind the screen, Sean Becker. If you just mouse over my video, there is an overlay there that called Dynamic Follow, and you can just click and automatically follow everybody. Everybody has content all different times of the week. When is the next time that we could see everybody streaming? Because I know Amy just dropped out on me tomorrow. We usually stream on Wednesdays, but she has something more important.
I might be streaming on Thursday evening. I might be filming, so not sure. But
I'm streaming Thursday.
We may be playing Friday, Felicia, right? Maybe?
Yes, I'm playing with Jeff. Yeah, I don't know what else we're doing.
Who else wants to,
We're playing.
I mean, I actually might
Fortnite.
Jump into that because I think my show is off this Friday.
That's weird. Okay. You weren't asked.
You weren't asked.
I mean, I'm inserting myself, so.
I might jump into it. Yeah, you might not either. Also. Yeah, you might, but you also might not. Possible you. We'll have to see how that goes. Yeah.
We love you, Ben.
It's Jafiv now.
Yeah. It would be too awkward to have a Friday stream without Vince right now.
Yeah, now it's gonna be weird.
It's like, they really didn't invite him.
Vince, if you want to start Sava,
it's weird, man.
We can.
It's kind of 50-50 right
now. We need more vowels in our life.
We just need a friend that's like, we need an Isabella or something.
Yeah.
Just I need so a tea.
Can I promote a thing?
Yes, of course. So
on Thursday, I'm not streaming, but on my channel, we're streaming a new show called Call Your Dad from two comedians, Scout Durwood and Catherine McCafferty, really funny comedians. And they get a dad improviser, just a dad improviser to pretend to be your dad. And you can call into the show, literally call into the show and ask that dad for advice. Something that maybe you are ashamed to actually ask your real dad, or maybe your dad's not with us or whatever, and you want dad advice, you can call in and get dad advice from Call Your Dad on Thursdays, I believe at 5. So that's the show that we're doing. It should be really fun. And
sounds fun, but you will not be there, to be clear.
I will be doing family raising and other things.
I know, no, it's fine. I just don't want anybody to be upset.
It's a show that's on my channel. We do these fun little formats, and so that's why we're doing it on Thursday.
Great, that's why it's not Cindy Parikh. It's effing funny because he has other people's stuff on there. But it is very.
Do you mind if I also mention something real quick?
Yeah, go ahead. Listen, we have 3 minutes. Kenny just left. Bye, Kenny. We love you.
On Sunday, I'm DMing a charity show on the Wizards of the Coast Twitch channel. That's twitch.tv/DND. On the main D&D Twitch channel, benefiting, I believe, No Kid Hungry, with a wonderful cast of people starting at 12 p.m. Pacific, going until about 3. It'll just be a silly, fun adventure, mostly with the cast of my show, Failed Save, just having a good time benefiting a wonderful cause to help childhood hunger. So, tune in for that.
Awesome. Jeff,
I just want to say a shout out to Stan Wells, who, because if it weren't for Stan Wells, mm-hmm. I would not be on the Guild, and I would not have met Felicia or Sandeep, and I would not have had some fun Friday nights. I remember the first time I met you, Felicia, and Sandeep too. I remember Stan Wells, I just want to thank him for.
Oh my gosh, he's so wonderful. If without Stan Wells, I would not be anywhere because when I first moved to town, I was in a horrible acting class that discouraged me from acting. I thought I was like a dramatic actress, and I auditioned for a play he wrote called Three, and got into his improv classes through that. I had never seen improv, never done comedy, never thought it was funny. And without him, I never would have even thought to do comedy at all and met wonderful people. So I encourage everybody to find a community that makes you happy, that you play with. You don't have to be a professional. Like the funniest people in that show, I want to give a shout out to Arthur Bullock, who actually recently passed away. He was an amazing improviser there. And there were just a group of people who He worked for Rand. He was just so funny, though.
Yeah.
Doctors, lawyers, like, you don't have to be, you can find wonderful friends and do wonderful creative stuff at improv class. So I just want to give a shout out to improv classes.
Yeah.
And improv class changed my life and informs everything I do.
Yeah.
Yep. Amy, when is the next time you're going to stream?
No idea.
Okay, hell great. Yeah.
Maybe Sunday. Well, I want to do Gardic Phone this weekend. So
whatever. Oh, that'd be fun.
I'm not sure this weekend.
Keep Amy's page open and on at all times.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, next week maybe.
At all times, yes.
Okay. And Robin, when are you going to stream next?
Thursday, actually. I'm going to, at 5:30. I'm going to do a little cooking deal, and then we're going to watch a movie.
Okay.
Yeah,
amazing. Dinner and the movie with Robin.
Dinner and the movie, yeah.
You do it with Amazon Prime, the watch show thing?
I have, yeah.
I don't know how that works.
But they don't have a lot of movies that are like broadly available. So we jump onto Discord after.
Oh, okay, cool. Oh, well, yeah, everybody does have Discords. Everybody check everybody out. Okay, if you guys want to leave one thing with the audience, just let's go around and finish this up. Thank you everybody for being here and supporting and being a fan for so many years. I'm so gratified that we're able to get together and just be friends again. Like, we've become more of a real guild than we ever have been.
Hell yeah.
And it's really fun. So I just want to leave a note with you guys. Thank you for supporting us and allowing us to make content that nobody else would let us make way earlier than anybody was making it. I will not say that it's the end of the characters of the guild. I can't promise anything, but the characters live in my heart and a lot more living, breathing way now, just from reuniting with everybody in the last year. So I will say that. So thank you. Anybody else? No?
I'm just saying that none of us are too famous to do more. So anytime you need us to.
Yeah, literally drop of a hat. Listen, you got a toilet, I'm swirling in it. I'm ready to go.
Great. Swirly bit.
Except Jeff.
Yeah, thank you, Felicia.
Big thanks to Felicia.
Yeah, definitely. Right, thank you.
Thank you, Felicia. And
thanks for thinking of me as a creepy stalker.
You're welcome. Romantically.
Yeah, not making me audition for that role. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, that's really sure. No, you did not have to audition. Everybody else.
I would have not gotten it.
I would have blown that audition for sure. So.
And I want to send a shout out to Kim Evie and all the directors of the Guild. And Sean, Greg Benson directed some episodes. Jane Sally Morgan directed the first season. Then Sean and Chris Prexta. But Sean really was the heart of the show and added so much. I just want to give a shout out to Sean behind the scenes.
He is the guild. He really does. Like.
Yep. So Sean Becker's the best. And with that, we will say adieu. Thank you so much for being here. Follow us all, and we will see you on Sunday nights, baby. Bye, everybody.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
So, it's Friday night, and still jobless, yay. My therapist broke up with me. Oh yeah, there's a gnome warlock in my living room, sleeping on my couch.
We're a local guild. It would be easy to meet. I mean, why haven't we met before?
I just have this game I play online. It's nothing important.
Sid Sherman, what is your problem?
Other than talking to my own face?
Hang with me in my MMO. So
I'm at your doorstep. Doorstepped.
Zabu?
This long distance thing is killing our relationship.
What? No, Zabu, we don't have a relationship. No, I mean, we're friends. Friends online, anonymously.
Oh, really?
It's not good.
I'm gonna stop kissing you now.
Yeah, please go.
Okay.
Do you wanna date my avatar?
I am Vork, guild leader of the Knights of Good.
Vork, is it? Is there a story behind that name?
Not for you. I want it on record that as his manager, I do not discriminate against anyone who's paying. I'm equally fond of everyone. People don't like me. I elicit repugnance and resentment in humans from all walks of life.
You don't have electricity?
Once I became a non-paid professional guildmaster, I had to cut the fat from life.
Vork, electricity isn't fat.
I love spending time with my family. This is so much better than gaming.
Just pay a small subscription.
Well, I tried an alias on another game, but my kid picked it up and started calling me Mominatrix.
Your kids are in a store right now without you?
Not entirely. Mommy's at the GameStop. I love you. Over. Kill the monsters.
Get monsters.
Tink, is that your real name?
Honey, stop grilling her.
Your real name is Tinkerbala? As far as you guys know, it is.
Well, let's go job at a fashion magazine as the assistant to the editor.
I know I don't have the looks to fit in, but I decided to stick it out, do whatever it takes to fulfill my dreams.
Yeah, that's the plot to Ugly Betty.
What a coincidence.
I have male minions taking care of everything.
My tests, my mechanic is fixing my car battery for free.
I'm juggling 15 sets of balls today, literally.
I hate it when I'm right. Wait, no I don't.
Anyone ever tell you your character looks like that cheesy pirate dude?
Looks like that dude, buddy. I am that dude. My mom forced me into modeling to pay for college. I'm not gonna use my real name. We have rooms and badges under the name Finn Smulders, okay? I don't want stalkers showing up to my door offering me their bodies unless they're double D certified. I'm sorry I was all douchey to you guys. It's just hard being exploited because I'm all hot and stuff.
Blade is ready to partay. I'll have my mom drop me off.
It's Friday night, no longer jobless, yay. Wow, I was such a mess when I started doing these, but now, not so much. It's because I have the guild. I guess healing them kind of helped heal me too. We're a team, we're friends. And yeah, I guess that's all I needed.